but that would have really sucked.
Mm-hmm. Can you not talk about death?
We're live. Speaking of dead characters, hey guys, welcome back.
I'm nervous.
Hey guys, it's no spoilers here.
No spoilers up here.
Wait, Zylo, it's not showing up in my
Oh my god, Zylo, sub boxes are broken.
All right, should be popping them now. It's officially live. Welcome to YouTube. I mean, the live
What's
stream.
YouTube?
I'm See, there
to
we go.
Three hit die, right?
We got Time Beast and Paper Crown, Camden, and of course, Darkflame.
Are we not on hitbox.tv?
Yeah, something like that.
Wait, we're not on VidMe? What the heck?
All right, so let me change this over to here. Change this All into right, our
guys,
random
send us
pre-game
your bits.
Rules.
This is Bits, come in, Bits.
Wait, this isn't Twitch?
We're going for the paper Are we cup, on, filling it today.
Vimeo's streaming service.
They just opened it up.
Oh my god.
Alright, good to see everyone here. We have some stuff to get into today. Before we begin, thank you guys, of course, for tuning in. Lots of cool videos going up lately on all the channels. Mostly, I think.
Yeah, for the most part. We're doing a lot of cool stuff.
Except for Panda.
Yeah.
It's all Panda's fault.
No cool videos going up over there, but you
know. No videos.
Oh.
Hey, yeah. I'm in that same boat.
Oh, but pretty much most of us, actually everybody here has started the new season of Yu-Gi-Oh.
I'm the only one that hasn't because,
garbage.
This week I'll start. Trust. I'll pump out all of the second season that I was in, and then season three's coming. Don't worry, guys.
Dark's there, though. He's in the world.
He's in my episode two.
Spoilers, man. Spoilers.
All right. Any more?
Yeah. Pinky Squad. Go sub to Pinky Squad, by the way.
Yeah. Standard.
Yeah, standard.
Everyone already knows about that.
If anybody here's not sub to Pinky Squad, go check that out.
But to those of you who are here and have no idea what's going on here, this is a stream we do every week, usually on Wednesday. Today it's on Tuesday because of scheduling. And we sit here and play D&D like a bunch of idiots to clear our minds and recharge our creativity for the rest of the week.
Yes.
So, anyone have anything else to say before we get into the game?
Dark for Pinky Squad.
He says it every week.
He does.
Hey, I will say myself. That this apple fritter is delicious.
Ooh.
Wait, yo, I thought you were eating applesauce.
Okay, I'm not gonna lie. There was some cookie dough sitting on my kitchen table all day today.
Bro,
I was like, someone making cookies?
Wait,
someone's gonna make
I'm
some cookies.
Over, I'll be right back.
Someone's gonna make some really good cookies. And they're my favorite, the oatmeal chocolate chip. You guys remember that for when you make me cookies. And they were just, the cookie dough was sitting on the table. And they're like, you know, they're supposed to be made and handed out as gifts. But there's always those extra cookies. And they were never made.
I would have just taken the cookie dough, honestly. Yeah. I would have been perfect.
So I was just thinking, like, oh, it's going to be any time now. It's going to be any time now all day.
Any time now. They're going to start. When you said oatmeal chocolate chip, I was, like, so scared you're going to say oatmeal raisin. And I'm like, I just can't talk to this guy anymore.
I think oatmeal raisin is okay, but, like, it's just because I love oatmeal cookies so much that I can survive through the raisins. I don't think they add anything to it.
The problem
is
you think the raisins are chocolate chips.
Like raisins, but, yes, they disguise themselves.
Yeah, if they deceive you, that's just mean.
You bite in, you're like, yes,
that's just mean. Anyway, Santa can figure out all the cookie stuff. We're getting into a game of Dungeons & Dragons in a Skyrim setting.
Does Santa drink almond milk?
I hope so.
Yeah.
Old Russian Santa.
That was like, that's all we got, man.
That's all we got in my house.
That was on sale this week.
Uh-huh.
That's all we got.
I love almond milk.
I've
anyway,
never had it.
I hate soy milk. So.
Sounds delicious.
We are going to begin.
You don't like soy milk?
Yeah, I'm not a fan.
I'm just going to walk away. I'm done.
Anyway, who wants to hit me with the previously on?
Tiger.
Previously on Skyrim D&D.
All right, ignoring the at the beginning of that. last time we
D&D without a pop screen.
Yes, that previously
better?
On. That it didn't even do it that time.
What do
I
you
know? That's
what
I have
fucking
thought.
Beautiful.
Filter.
All right, previously.
I had one.
Previously on.
Mm-hmm. So anyway, so these travelers set out to help. Someone helped relieve a town they had visited previously on this, and they went to Drakesville. They found their favorite caravan driver, Corvin, who had recently purchased a spear so he could help fend off enemies and protect his beloved horse, Cheryl. Anyway, when they got to the town, they realized it was overrun. People were in hiding. There was two ogres sitting in the middle of town just eating meat. And they eventually were able to take out the ogres. Tiger came from out of nowhere, shot the ogre through the one eye it still had, and they were able to rescue the town. However, everyone in the town still felt threatened, so they decided to all, you know, evacuate to Riften. It was a dangerous road where they were stalked most of the way by goblins until they finally attacked, using the fog cloud to protect most of the people but also obscure them. They were able to fend off the goblins and save most of the people, but there were some casualties. They eventually returned to the town of Riften, were thanked by the survivors, and took a nice rest in the tavern before beginning their day now.
Can we get rid of this other little tiger on the screen?
No, I like him. That's my real friend.
Oh.
I'm impressed the
He's down. He's gone. So is that little red dot.
Tiger down.
Okay.
So, what would you guys like to do to start?
Well, I suppose we wake up in the tavern as we generally
like
do.
Diddy.
And I feel naked.
And I'm down in, you know, down by the tables, like not up in the rooms, but down by the tables wearing his armor.
I'm gonna go downstairs.
Okay. This is not awkward. Me and Chris are just gonna stay in our room.
I'm walking down the stairs.
So let's just get this straight.
It's weird.
You went to the tavern, had a drinking contest, and when we next see you, you're wearing another man's armor. Cool.
Okay.
Continue the story.
No, I stole his armor while he was sleeping.
How did you steal my armor? You were the one who was, like, wasted. Like, I was perfectly fine.
I recovered pretty quickly.
I don't get
hangovers.
I see Matt sitting there, looking all cheeky in my armor.
Oh, what's up, dude? How you doing?
What's up? Why are you wearing my armor, bro?
Well, you know, I thought it looked better on me anyway.
What is this, a fashion contest?
No, it's just, you know, you've seen out there, I need a little more protection. I mean, try my armor on. You'll like it, I think.
But your armor smells like Mev.
It'll smell like you, eventually. You're a furry animal.
You saying I stink?
Yes.
How do you know I bathe myself twice a day?
I'm gonna walk down the stairs, see them fighting, one of them's naked, and I'm gonna walk back into my room.
Do you think licking yourself from head to toe really gets rid of the
stink?
Actually,
I'm gonna hear
though?
That, and then
yeah,
I'm gonna walk into my room.
I do!
Okay,
you know,
we
have cleaner mouths than people do, you know?
Okay.
Or is that dogs? I don't know.
Whatever,
regardless.
Dude. But anyway, try my armor on. Before you kill me or whatever, can you try my armor on?
Walk into the room.
Only because it's chilly.
What?
You walk into the room, you see these two arguing as Fluffles is putting on Mevidus' armor.
What? This isn't too bad. Hello?
See?
I dig the leather.
Guys?
I thought leather would suit you.
Mev?
Oh,
it's less
hey, what's
cold.
Up, guys?
What are you two doing? Are you guys, trying out different styles of fashion?
I stole his armor and am trying to convince him to switch.
Okay.
You stole it. This is a lot easier to move in, I'll admit.
See? So what do you say?
But aren't you gonna smell like Mev?
Sure, swapsies.
Swapsies it is.
A gentleman's agreement.
But Fluffles, aren't you gonna smell like Mev?
I'm just not gonna question
Mev doesn't
it.
Smell
just
that
let,
bad.
Just let him do it.
Yeah,
Out of you three humans, Mev smells the worst.
See?
He does smell pretty bad.
Wait, the
yeah.
least
no,
worst.
No, you already said it. You said the worst.
The least that worst?
One. Look, I... Never mind. Okay, so what are we gonna do today, guys?
I don't know.
Let's go back to that dungeon.
Wait, if we're doing dungeon stuff, we need to go to a shop first.
Why?
I used up most of my arrows against those goblins yesterday.
All right, let's go buy some more arrows.
I'm literally
Mr.
down
Fluffles.
To the arcane ones, and I really don't want to use those unless we need to.
All right,
that's
Mr.
true.
Fluffles,
I got about
you.
17 arrows myself. I could probably use a couple.
Somebody
more,
want to go secure Corvin for the day?
I got you. I'll go get Corvin.
I guess I'll come with you. You guys go.
He's really the best carriage driver we know, isn't he?
Do you guys have money or
like
no?
He's the only one.
I have
no.
That's true. Actually,
you
he
take
is
all
the only
of our money.
I take all of your money. Get it
right.
The only
money I was able to scavenge when I was gone, I spent on Julio.
Really?
Spend your money on Wait, how did you get money while you were gone?
I told you not to worry about it.
I'm kind of worried about it now. Have you been meeting up with your Khajiit friend?
Give me some money so I can get some arrows.
Fatal give us some
arrows.
We'll all
go out together and get it.
Okay.
Actually, I don't know how much it cost.
I don't know.
We'll go find someone that can sell them.
Come on. Yeah, normally, you can pay one gold piece for a quiver full of arrows.
How much is in the quiver?
That's cheap. 20, I think.
Mm-hmm. I'll buy a quiver.
Wait, but if I have 9, can I hold more than that? Do I have to
Not
buy 11?
Really, no.
Can I get another quiver and dual quiver?
You could, you know, if weight's not a concern of yours.
How much does my quiver weigh?
It's probably not that heavy, but
a couple pounds, I think.
Yeah, it's probably would be a little difficult to carry around, because think about it, you got your quiver on your back, you have your bow on your back, and it's a long bow too, so it's already a little unwieldy, and then you got your two decent sized swords on the sides. So, and you're not a big dude or anything, so I feel like when it comes to weapons, you're kind of close to the limit there. So another quiver might make things a little awkward.
Push it real good. Dun, 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 dun.
Like maybe you could find someone who could make you a bigger quiver or something, but
Ooh, let's
or
ask.
You might find one.
Or
maybe I could try to argue a trade in value on your other arrows.
No, those arrows are special. I like arrows. We might need those arrows.
Get like we will.
Seldomly use those arrows, but that's because I seldomly remember I have those arrows.
Yeah. Sorry, guys, I dropped my lucky coin. Give me two.
Ooh, okay. Lucky coin.
I have a lucky coin too.
Don't want to lose it.
Alright.
Julio, steal the lucky coin.
Hey, no. Slap Tiger on the cheeks. Bubble.
Okay, yeah, so as you guys are trying to decide what to do, the Khajiit with the, short golden fur that you have seen in the town of Drakesfell, the one that ran the tavern, walks up to you. You remember his name is Jahaji, and he just makes sure to thank you guys again for, like, everything you did for the town. So thank you all.
No
very
problem.
Good that you helped us.
We're sorry you lost 2 men.
No problem, sir. And sorry we couldn't save all the people of the town.
Well, it's because of you that some of the people were saved. So, you have our thanks. The people may not be able to do much for you, but you have my thanks.
Okay, well, yeah. Of course, if there's anything else we can ever do...
It's what we do.
Let us know.
Well, I was coming to you for that, actually.
Of course he was.
It's not a big deal. It's,
What do you need?
You see, many of the refugees here, they do not have much, and... They will have a hard time surviving. Me, personally, I decided to leave Riften. I cannot return to Drakesville, so... My cousin here, he runs a caravan that is actually passing through here. And if you guys would like to help escort it through the dangerous territories in the south, just in case more of the giants and ogres attack, you could be handsomely rewarded.
That would be fun.
Ooh, handsomely rewarded. I like the sound of that.
It is just escort, and maybe nothing will happen, but I believe it would be a lot safer if you were around.
Exactly. So let me see. Where are we going?
We didn't have any other plans today, did we?
Well, first, we need arrows, and then I'm down to go.
Well,
when are we leaving?
Time to get prepared.
When's this caravan?
Well, if you help this caravan move, we can easily supply you with arrows. My cousin, he deals in a certain weapon vendoring. Across Skyrim.
Okay.
I believe the next destination is Helgen. To the
save us a trip.
West.
Can we bring Corvin with us?
Who?
The carriage driver.
But they already have a carriage.
The small whiny man that you were traveling with.
He's not whiny, he's very strong.
Yes, but Flagel,
he's learning how to use a spear.
I mean, I suppose if he would like to accompany us as well, it would not be a problem.
I mean, we're on the way to Falkreath, and weren't we going to go there before many distractions happened?
We were going to go to Falkreath.
I think we should still go to Falkreath.
Let's do it.
But why were we going to go to Falkreath? Do either
Dargan words.
Dargan?
Remember old man we got to talk to? the
yes, but we Falkreath. Found that we found that ruin, the dungeon on the lake. On Falkreath.
That's true. We that never went back there either.
Well, it was kind of like between track. You know.
Helgen's pretty far
those
from
areas.
There.
We can go to Helgen, then go to Falkreath, and then go back to the lake.
Yeah, we could do that.
Could.
That sounds right, like a plan to me. I'm down.
Let us go get Corvin. We're gonna need somebody to transport us after, anyways.
Very yes. well, very well.
And then we'll get some more supplies, and then where do you guys, what do you want us to meet?
We are positioned just outside of town, in the Western Gate.
How long okay. do we have?
The sooner the better we can take off, not waste much daylight.
Okay, we'll be quick.
Alright. Kratos, you go with Fluffles. You guys go get arrows. Me and Mev yeah. will go get
But they have arrows.
Corvin.
We don't need
I don't know
to go
why
anywhere.
You told me to go get more arrows, Plato. He just said more arrows on the caravan.
Yeah, man.
But do you really want to take their arrows?
Yes.
yes. I mean, he was saying he... Like, he was, they sell weapons and arrows. So you assume yeah. they have a very good supply of weapons and arrows that, you know...
If I'm gonna use those arrows to defend them, then yeah, I'll take
are generally for
from
sale,
them.
And it would just essentially be part of your payment, just to make it easier.
Yeah, that sounds good. Let's all just get. Where's Corbin? You guys
yeah.
see?
Saves
guys
us
see
time.
His...
Right. Saves them money.
You see what Cheryl about? Around anywhere?
Let's all go find.
You guys turn around, Corbin. And Corbin's just leaning on the side of a building with his hand just outstretched.
what
hey
are you doing,
guys,
Corbin?
You need help again?
Yeah, of course.
He slips in the mud a little bit and it almost falls on the ground, catches himself on the wall. Okay. I mean,
are you okay, Corvin?
Yeah, I'm just practicing my moves in case we're attacked again.
It's looking good.
Yeah, looking good, Corby.
Yeah, we're working
shaky,
on it. We're working
actually.
On it. Yeah, it's all about the landing, and you know, I didn't land on the ground, so doing something right this time.
Fair enough, guys. I'll give you that one, man.
All right, do guys. You want to get some experience with this, Corvin?
I mean, I'm really in it for the experiences, but I mean, if you guys are also paying, you know, Cheryl's always up for more adventures.
Yeah, sure. Come
she's,
on.
She's course, the adventurous one.
All right, she... Plato, give him all the copper.
Oh
hey,
yeah,
50 copper, buddy.
Thanks. Where are we going?
We're headed towards Falkreath with the Khajiit caravan.
Back through the dangerous goblin and
we're escorting
ogre.
Yep. And then you're going to take us around the tours for Falkreath. You know that area pretty well, right?
Just because I have to right. actually, you know,
take,
run my caravan. Could you, okay, that'll work. Thanks.
You want another 5 copper? Here you go.
Great. Sure.
All right, let's go.
Sorry, Cheryl. Just oh, loads on Cheryl. Another heavy bag of copper onto the car. All right.
You want to do to the poor animal.
So baby. Another journey, just the 5 of us. Let's go.
Well, there's Khajiit caravan too, but yeah.
Oh.
Just the 5 of us.
Yes.
Just the 15 or something of us. Let's go. Yeah. Corvin does his standard move. Yeah, Cheryl does nothing at first, kind of just sits there. Cheryl, yeah! And then starts off to a slow trot.
So guys, how many of those orbs are we still rocking?
I don't
I
know.
It was gone a while, so I assume you used them all.
No, we actually haven't we used any since you left.
So
really?
I think we still have the same amount, which is how many, Mev?
yeah, Mev.
Yeah,
he's
Mev.
Still holding them.
I guess I open up the box
mm-hmm.
to reveal.
And you add Xylo. How many we have left?
Well,
two
I don't know.
Blue,
how many did you write in your
brown,
inventory?
One red, one green. We actually have it in the handouts.
Yeah, you actually do all have it.
We have one red, one green, two
is that
brown, two
accurate?
Blue, one black.
It is.
Or is it? Okay.
Mm-hmm.
I was just wondering if Mev had it. Had all
I
the stuff available too. Yeah.
Case.
You used all the purple ones, which were invisibility
is
spells
it?
Cast
yeah.
upon you.
And
but
yellow
you still
was
have the other ones.
Blue is water breathing, right?
Yeah.
Yes.
I
green
used
is
the
dashing.
Off the bat, which was
which one?
Healing.
Mm-hmm.
Green is speed.
Haste. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a haste spell.
Black is night vision.
Which means you
red
can mine
is...
faster. I mean,
oh, red. Yeah. The
you
red.
Say red.
Red's the fun
yes.
one.
Wait, then there's brown. What was brown?
Bark skin.
Oh.
You know, in case any of you need more AC.
Oh, then give it to me.
I need it more than you.
We need you both. We have 2, right?
No.
Oh, well, I'm taking it.
Okay.
Well, alright. I'm just making sure, taking inventory, you know.
So I guess, the guy we're meeting, Corbin, he's right outside the West Gate.
Alright then.
Alright.
So I guess we go outside the West Gate and meet the,
You guys head out there. Yeah, you run into a, one of those standard, Skyrim groups of Khajiit just chilling outside the city. You know, they got two guards who are wearing, some heavy armor. It's just chainmail, but they got, some rugged plates and, leather bits. As the guards. Yeah, you would definitely recognize this, this cultural means of a living, tiger. And there is also, a few people just carrying supplies around. And, then there's just a few Khajiit there. It's about 9 of them.
Yo, so where are the arrows at?
yes, we have them prepared for you right here.
Jahaji. You guys got any bigger quivers? Yes, I mean, I'm willing to pay.
We do not have any bigger quivers. We do have several bows for sale, but you may be well equipped already.
What about bows?
Could you spare maybe 3 more arrows for me, maybe?
Sure. I mean, of course, this will be cut out of your paycheck, but...
Yeah.
Well, I don't know if Matt needs those arrows.
It's a good deal, good business.
How much could 3 arrows cost?
That will be 40
we
gold.
Don't really need any money
for it. I'm kidding. Don't worry about it.
And besides, you may need them. Why would you need arrows anyway? You can't hit anything to save your life.
Hey, I've seen you try to throw a javelin, so don't talk to me like that.
I can throw a javelin.
He has a point.
All right, I can't throw a javelin. And plus a javelin is quite different something. Than a bow. Yeah.
Anyway,
and he doesn't really use javelins ever. Uses the bow.
I might be able to use a bow.
Man, Corbin might be able to use a bow.
Corbin,
how do you use a bow? Can I see one of your guys' bows?
Whoa. Give me your bow, Mev.
Give me your bow, Mev.
Give me your bow, Mev. My bow?
Yeah. Yes.
Well, he's sure not getting mine.
Or mine.
Do you have a bow?
Kratos, I have a short bow.
I have a short bow too. I don't know if I've ever seen you use yours.
I have.
Yeah, Kratos, give me your short bow. You have javelins, apparently.
I have one javelin. He has one javelin. I have
a
javelin.
I mean, it's fine if it's a problem, guys. I was just asking. Just in case, because, I mean, I'm okay with the spear, but it didn't work so great last time.
Yeah, you did great.
Hurt a little bit. Maybe staying back and being an archer might not be a bad idea. We can try it out.
Do you know how to use a bow, Corvin?
No.
You can learn. I can teach you. I don't know how to use a bow.
And then Jahaji just gets into straight trader mode and starts talking to him. Ah, yes, perhaps that would use my training, but the crossbow may be more your speed. I believe we have several for sale here. And you just see these two talking, and Corbin's just like, okay. Just sure.
You want some copper? You need to buy a crossbow, Corbin?
Yes, I mean, a crossbow would be generally copper, right? About 30 gold.
How about 50 copper?
How about, I believe for this journey, if you'll take us there, where do you want to take us to? Helgen, any further? I suppose.
Where are you guys going? Is that Helgen your final stop? Or?
That is our stop, yes. I mean, honestly, we only need your help to get past Drakesville and the dangerous area there.
We can take you all the way if you really want us to.
We're probably going to go all the way to Helgen.
Yeah, we may as well just go all the way to Helgen.
Well then, I believe that we'd be able to offer you maybe the crossbow and an additional 20 gold. That's value of 50 gold for a simple escort.
I mean, Corvin, do you want a crossbow? Because the money's not really anything to us. I don't need it.
I mean, if it means I don't have to go stabbing ogres again, it's might be useful.
Yeah, and then we can consider that a bonus for all the help you've given us.
Yes. Oh, awesome. I mean, as long as it helps keep everyone alive, I'll do my part.
I like it. Can we get the crossbow in advance, though?
Oh, yes, sure, of course.
Might be useful.
To help defend.
Absolutely.
Please don't shoot us.
Yeah, it's the one thing I ask.
We mean,
Should I try it out or something?
No, I'm sure you're fine.
Maybe a little bit.
Corbin is an expert warrior, and we're in really good hands with him helping defend you.
I'm sure.
Okay.
So you do remember I was there when the goblin attacked.
He was there.
Alright.
Alright, so are you guys ready, or you need a little bit more time?
Yes, I suppose everyone is ready to go.
You guys need any help with anything?
We should have everything in order. You just handle security and we should be fine. Koshiba! We are ready to move. And then you just see a female, because she kind of just like stand up. She has like a walking stick in her hand. And,
hey, Tiger, Tiger, you see her?
Hey, Fluffles? Huh?
Huh?
Got my speed, man.
Huh?
Not my speed.
I'm not into walking sticks.
Can smack Vlado over the back of the head. What's wrong with you?
Racist.
I was just trying to get him a friend, you know?
I think all Khajiit look alike.
She has like copper scale mail glistening in the sunlight.
It's glistening. Come on. Huh. Look at that. It's like meant to be.
Dude, look divine at her glisten.
Akatosh is telling you.
She's like a very, very light-colored fur.
It's light-colored fur? That's rare.
And her mane is blowing in the wind.
It's blowing in the wind. Divine intervention.
Guys, do you hear an echo?
You like her so much. Why don't you go after her?
Yeah.
I'm not, she seems more like I'm just saying speed. For you.
Plato, she seems more like your speed.
You know.
I want a strong Nord.
So you guys keep talking about this as the caravan starts to move.
Okay, guys, let's start going. Come on, Corbin.
Yeah, come on, Corbin.
Yeah, I'm already moving.
Okay. All right.
Yeah, the whole thing is moving. How do you guys want to position it out to? Because you're officially, you know, helping guard this thing. They got like two guards and some other people are armed there, but you guys are essentially in charge because, you know, giants and ogres aren't anything to mess around with. So.
I guess we'll be in.
Okay. Corbin on the front. leading this train.
Okay.
I don't like that.
Wait, what?
Just marching in the front, playing your drum in a slow pace, pretending you're controlling a march.
The thing boom, with Corbin. Boom.
Unless I'm with Corbin, in which case, then that's okay.
I think we're all
Tiger
Corbin,
should be in the back of the cart with the bow in the, in the cart with Corbin. Yeah.
Where's the card? Is that like in the back or the front?
We're surrounded.
I think you guys should be in the back.
I agree.
Corbin should be in the back.
Okay.
Me and Dark should be at front, and then I don't know where Mev wants to be.
Mev's going to be with Tiger.
Mev's just standing in front of you guys going, boom,
I really need to be up front, because we have all these Khajiit. They can all
you
see
just need
at
to
night.
Watch our back, pretty much.
Yeah.
You just watch
I'll
out
stay
for
with
everything.
Corbin.
Just keep your eyes moving, all right?
So Tiger's keeping an eye on the back. The rest of you guys are kind of keeping an eye out on everything in the front as you're moving forward. Okay.
Mm-hmm. Of course, examining the sides as we go a little bit.
Yeah, sure. Let's see. I'm going to roll a die here. Everyone make perception check.
Oh, God. We're dead.
Why long is this?
All right, Vlado. Killing it.
Oh, God.
I'm always killing it.
I'm in the back. That's why I can't see very good right now.
I'm still on the over.
Oh, God.
Mevidus, what do you see?
Nothing.
Hold on, your boy's about to come in here.
Corbin!
Nope.
No one.
Corbin is one of us.
So you continue along, everyone's kind of keeping real steady. Yeah, nothing really major happens. You got a pretty big group moving.
Dunley, pineapples.
But yeah, you keep moving as the day progresses. A lot of these people are walking, so you're not, like, traveling at, you know, carriage speed. Mm-hmm. But, that you know, they're moving all their goods and stuff, so it's essentially a walking pace. So later in the day, you kind of pass by a beggar's rest, as you've passed by many times. Nothing seems to be any different than usual, so.
Probably abandoned at this point, isn't it?
Yeah, it's been abandoned this whole time, essentially, every time you pass by it. Because the first time you passed by it, it was, like, a smoking husk. And then ever since then, you know, no one's even considered going back there. Even you
honestly,
guys were keeping a wide berth around it.
Yeah, we don't really need to. I don't think we need to be so wary of it anymore. No reason for anything to live there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so you guys continue, and you don't make it too far before sun sets. The Khajiit, you know, continue to keep moving as the sun sets and don't really say anything about it. What would you guys like to do?
Where are we
leave it up to
just
them.
Past beggars?
We're not in charge right now.
Yeah,
you're
yeah,
in charge.
Just past beggars.
I thought we were in charge. Cause
yeah, you can absolutely just say, but like, we're going to stop for the night, and they would follow, but
they've done this
I think
before,
we should
though.
Be fine. We have a caravan of Khajiit who can all see at night, I assume.
Yeah, yeah. You talk with a few of them, and you get the feeling that they just kind of go until they're...
They're tired,
yeah, because they can see fine at night.
Okay, so I guess we keep moving.
How's everyone feeling? We feeling good for a night run?
Hey, I'm cool. I'm chilling. Let's keep going.
All right.
Okay. Yeah, you continue on. probably crests a little bit towards midnight when you see the town of Drakesfell in the distance.
I don't know if we want to camp here, dang. We probably should have stopped.
I mean, you can, like, go off into the woods and find somewhere out of sight from it, if you would like to. Or you could pass it a little bit if you would like to. Your choice.
I mean, if we're basically there, we may as well camp there.
No. You remember, there was supposed to be another ogre or two still here.
Couple ogres.
Yeah, but we're already in the area. We may as well have cover as opposed to being out in the woods.
I thought I'd be in the woods.
Okay. I guess.
I think we should go a little bit past Drakesfell.
Yeah, that would probably be better.
Maybe an hour past Drakesfell.
I don't know, I just don't like being in the vicinity of this town.
Yeah, hey, I don't either.
Whatever you paladins say, you guys are in charge.
Getting pretty sick of these paladins, Mav.
Excuse me, you want to say that again?
Just listen to him.
As you guys are passing Drakesfell, everyone want to make another perception check?
Lucky I'm not.
It's
going to
be
Gordius.
At disadvantage for those without night vision.
So nice, I had a good roll for
nice
me.
Two.
Nice one.
13. Maybe you got a one.
One. I guess me and Tiger.
You guys see anything?
I ain't nope. seen nothing.
Yeah, something. Kratos and Fluffles, you do notice that the tavern is not exactly in the state you left it. The entrance, where there once was like a door and like, you know, a little overhang and, you know, some posts there, just looks like it's completely blown out or just like destroyed. And there's just like a big hole in the building where the front entrance used to be. But nothing's moving in there. There's no fires burning or anything. It just looks damaged.
Guys. See that? We can't stay there. Look at that.
You didn't even know what was going on.
Are you scared?
I'm just relaying what you just told me.
I am?
Yeah, you
I
told
just
me that.
Saw it.
Right?
No.
No.
Tavern isn't in
Fluffles,
the
don't you think these guys
it?
Are pretty cowardly for
they're
kind of
dumb, too. I mean,
we're
what
smart.
Good does it do us to
I'm
not
right
be in town? We have, like, a bazillion carriages. If the ogres are going to spot us, they're going to see us just as good in the woods.
As you guys are walking, Mev steps into a little pit of sunken ground. It's, like,
nice.
A couple inches lower than the rest of the ground was. And, you know, you catch yourself almost trip, but you're fine.
Ooh.
Just because you rolled a one on your perception, you didn't see it. But it actually looks like a very large footprint.
Mm-hmm. Oh, is it pointing?
Can
we tell?
A little ditch.
Which
doesn't look
pointed?
Like a ditch?
It's pointed back the way you came, sort of.
Oh, okay. So let's keep moving forward, then.
That Mev, I don't think that was a ditch. I think that was a footprint.
Oh! Oh my god! Okay, yeah, maybe we should keep moving.
Oh, we're cowards, huh?
You see how big that thing is?
It's pointed from the way we came, which means we're walking that way, correct?
We don't know if they're gonna come back towards us.
It looks like they, like you guys are heading west right now, and it's generally the footprint, and you can see a couple of them now that you actually notice this and you're looking for them. These are definitely what you think might be like ogre or giant footprints, and they're headed to more of the east, southeast direction.
So towards Beggar's Rest?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I think we should still keep moving just to be safe.
That's up to the caravan.
It is fine.
Are you guys
tired?
Keep
moving. We can go a little longer.
30 or 40 minutes.
There's not another town until Wormshire there.
But this town's already destroyed as it is.
Well, we're going to be caught out in the middle of nowhere.
We'll be fine. We can stay in the woods somewhere.
Yeah, we'll be
as long
fine.
As long as we stay guard, look, have a guard, we'll be fine.
Why don't we go to the lake? We can stop there.
That's
that
kind
lake
of far.
Had,
yeah.
What happened to the lake?
With your,
Nope.
Yeah, ranger tracking you.
You don't remember the skeletons
further.
That came out of the water?
Well, go an
so, what do you guys want to do?
We're going to go one more hour west and then camp wherever we stop.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And then we're going to keep watch.
Okay.
Yes.
Yeah, you get that far just fine. You find a good little area that would be good for a camp. There's some trees around the outsides. It's like a little, you know, it's an area in the forest, but, you know, there's plenty of room for you guys to set up tents and stuff. Get a little bit of a defensive outlook on it. Off the road.
Cool.
Okay, I like it. And then I guess we'll just have people stay watch.
Yeah.
Yep.
I guess those other guards just... Are they Khajiits, those other two guards?
Yeah.
Everyone's Khajiit, I think.
We should try to have one of them up when we're with us so we can actually see.
We have
the talk about it, and they're offering to help keep watch. So you guys managed to find a schedule that works out for you.
Yeah, because this one always want a Khajiit, so we can actually have some night vision.
Sure. And we'll roll that die.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
I'm nervous. That's what he's doing.
Who has first watch?
Fluffles. Sure. I'll take it.
The Fluffles right. And not an actual guard from the caravan, then.
Okay.
So and Corbin.
It's just Fluffles. And...
Yeah, Corbin stays up with you. He talks to you about, with the bow shooting, like, how do you hit things every time? Is there, like, a trick to it or something?
You aim.
Aim? Okay. So, like, you aim at the target? Do you, like, aim above it? Is there, like, wind that I have to worry about? I know if I lick my finger and put it up in the wind, I can tell which way it's going.
Well, you can use different things. I mean, there's tree branches. Maybe
observation
maybe
those will be moving.
You could use observation hockey, as our passed out friend just said.
I don't know what that means.
Yeah, you probably shouldn't. I don't know. You could use your hair.
See
which way that's blowing. Yeah, there's tons of things.
Okay. I guess I'll just hope for the best.
Probably the best call.
He's just sitting there fiddling with this crossbow, like, how do I use this thing? He keeps, like, winding it up to get the string back and everything, and then just, like letting it loose into the ground, and like, okay. So that's working. He's practicing his reloading time.
He's fast with it.
Yeah, it's actually starting to make a little bit of noise you're noticing. Is it just a consistent, just, like, twang? So.
Corbin? Could you shut up, please, so we can sleep? He just woke me up.
Fair enough. Yeah, Tiger, make a perception check as you're keeping watch. Okay. Yeah, you notice there's some movement, and when you look closer, you see it's definitely another goblin, much like the ones you've seen before, kind of peeking through the tree line. But it's not like a large group of them like before. There's, like, the occasional goblin popping up throughout the watch. There's no whooping going on. They're trying to be real quiet.
Dang.
And the second you see one peek up, you, like, lock eyes with it, and it just, like, darts off.
I don't say anything. I just assume they're trying to pass. Trying to see what's up.
Okay. Whoop. Let's see. Yeah,
keep it in mind, though.
End your watch, go to bed. Jahaji is taking the next watch with who?
Me.
I guess I'll go. Okay. Raiders can go.
Cool. Yeah.
Yeah, it's a lot of the same thing. He makes note of it to you that there was like a goblin scout or something looking there.
Should be fine.
But nothing happens throughout the night. Yeah, you guys end up cycling through your watch thing and nothing attacks you, despite danger definitely being in the area.
Okay.
They saw what we did. They scared.
We did wipe out pretty much all of them.
And now you're with the large group, too, so.
And they see me with my shiny new elven armor, and they're like, whoa.
That they do.
I mean, we did have a large group before, too.
Naturally, like, more scary than just random.
Yeah, like, that's the thing. If you guys were just, like, a bunch of travelers that, you know, I think the goblins would understand it, because you can actually see them sneaking up, so. It's not as good of a situation. But yeah, the sun rises. You guys sleep in a little bit, get yourself a cat nap, and prepare to move out again.
All right.
Do you think we'll make it to Helgen today? Probably not, huh?
I think we'll need one more day.
Not all the way to Helgen.
Think we'll make it to a town?
If we truck, or we might make it to Wormshirth.
Yes. If we go all day long and don't take too many breaks, Wormsbirth may be a good target.
I think that's what we should aim for.
We could get there
all those goblins last night.
Oh, those were merely scouts. They should not be a problem.
Especially with this big group that we have.
I'm sure they saw you, gentlemen, and decided not to attack again.
Absolutely. Alright.
They may go back to warn their friends, but as long as we keep moving, we should be able to stay away.
Alright.
Okay, so we begin to head out, I guess?
To the west we go.
Yeah, you guys travel.
East.
You keep going throughout the day. Anything you guys want to do or mention while you're traveling? Yeah, you can see the lake in the distance as you move by.
Probably see it, but we're getting paid to do something right now. We can't do anything.
Yeah, I mean, you could bring it up with them and, you know, ask if they're good.
We're not going to try and explore a dungeon we don't know how big is.
Okay. With the caravan behind us.
Hey, come on, guys, it's safe.
Yeah, just wait here.
We'll be going for anywhere from 1 to 17 days.
Yeah, so I guess we just keep heading west. Hey, Corbin, how you doing with that crossbow there, bud?
It's fine. I think I got the hang of it. I really kind of want to test it out, though.
You don't sound too... Fine. Where do you want to test it out? You want to test it out on that tree over there?
Sure.
Test it out on Blado?
Sure. I mean, I'm kidding. Armor.
Okay, aim at that tree. Is that tree that's coming up, at the one we're right about to pass?
Ooh, moving target, okay.
Yeah, aim for that tree.
You're not even going to start him off with okay.
Come on, I got this. It'll be easy. Maybe. Okay, that tree?
Probably the best thing is to see what his natural tendencies are.
He hits the tree.
It's not a bad shot.
See?
It's a little crooked, but it'll work.
Yeah. The bolt lodges itself into the tree. I got it!
Somebody will get his bolt for him.
He starts reloading the crossbow.
Okay, alright. I think that's enough for now.
One more!
Okay, one more.
It soars past the person going to retrieve it as... okay. Not
Watch
doing
when you're
that.
Aiming that thing.
No, I got it now. I'll do it how I did the first time.
Okay, yeah, just do that instead of the way you did it the second time and you'll be all good.
Perfect!
Alright, well, I got the one. Where's the other one?
You don't know.
Yeah, I think it's
that
a
thing
lost
is
cause.
Lost in the grass. Yeah, you can't find it. But
all right.
Well, I got one here.
Thanks. He takes
it. Be careful where you aim that.
Fine.
I almost lost some hair.
You
guys end up keep traveling, and it seems like it goes pretty peacefully. Night falls again, but you keep moving as you did the day before, and before long, you can see the lights of Wormsbirth in the distance.
Alright, I guess we're gonna go there.
Alright.
Wormsbirth we are.
Yeah, as you approach it, Jahaji starts talking to you and is like, I think this should be far enough if this is good enough for you guys.
We
passed through
here.
The
That's
dangerous
fine.
Territory.
We can take you to Helgen.
Oh, it's just not necessary.
Not a problem.
Okay, yeah, I mean... The pay is still the same, right?
Of course. The crossbow and 20 gold.
I mean, are we going to Falkreath anyways? We may as well just go
to
Helgen.
Yeah, I mean, we might as well just go. We're going to Falkreath.
Plus, Helgen's a big city, and maybe we'll have some cool
shops.
Yeah,
maybe there's something in Helgen we could find.
Fair enough. I just heard some of you talking about maybe visiting another destination on the way, but...
I mean, maybe we go to Helgen, resupply, and then go check it out.
Well, we might
maybe
even
we can
be
see
able
if there's anything we know.
We might even be able to resupply here in Wormsworth and then go back to that dungeon. We're still, I don't know, what, about a half a day's away from there, I'd say?
Yes, still rather far from Helgen, but...
Yeah, I know, if we were to go from here, we're about half a day's away from that dungeon that we went to.
Yeah, you're
well,
about
I don't know,
equal distance.
What do the paladins think? Because, I mean... At the end of the day, our opinions don't matter, Metaphysis.
Yeah, that's true.
Well, I mean, I kind of want to go to Falkreath, but at the same time, I do want to explore the dungeon.
What are we going for Falkreath again for again? We've
I just
want so to
see
much,
it.
I don't even
I've heard
remember.
It's beautiful.
In the nature of Akatosh, we have to finish this.
So we're
we have to
sightseeing?
Well, we got to take these guys to Helgen first.
We have to help them.
They already agreed that we've
No, we got to take them to Helgen.
Yeah, they were talking about it, and the big danger was, like, all the... You know, giants and ogres that have been sighted between, like, Drake's Fell and Beggar's Rest, and you guys are way out of that territory now. You haven't seen anything since the goblins the night before, any signs of danger.
What is the deal with you paladins? He's agreed to pay us full price and says the job has been done. What other question is there?
Akatosh?
Ugh. Does Akatosh also demand we go to Falkreath to go sightseeing?
We don't have to go
does
to Falkreath, but we have to go to Helgen.
Pay Corvin and Strictly Copper?
No,
hey, he likes
clear.
The copper.
I don't think he does.
I'm giving him something that isn't copper.
And that's very good of you, Kratos. But I'm referring to our cheap paladin friend here. Blade.
I'm not cheap. I buy us plenty of good
You've
rooms.
Always been a penny pincher, haven't you? Or a copper pincher, rather.
Anyway, So, what are we doing, Paladins?
We're gonna go Falkreath. We have to finish this out.
What are doing in Falkreath? I still haven't been told, besides sightseeing.
We're not doing anything in
Falkreath.
Wasn't
there rumors of potentially finding some Dargon words?
Dragonthoom.
That.
Yes. See, now you bring up a good point. I completely forgot about that.
That's why we want. That's that why we were going that dungeon in the first place.
That was just a stop we made.
Yeah.
I thought we were on some quest to get you Dargon words.
Yes, and our original destination was Falkreath. We just so happened to stop at that lake first.
Yes.
And didn't we see some of the Dargon words on the place that we went into?
We didn't.
Did, then he would know them.
Yeah.
We just found
a
dungeon.
I mean, didn't we see some kind of carvings that made us think that it was?
That was just the dragon. That's just the symbol of the dragons. That's nothing.
You would think, with your knowledge of Akatosh and all that, that would hint towards there being something more in there.
Yeah, I know. Like, the carvings on the outside don't mean anything, but inside is what matters.
Okay, fine. We'll do whatever you guys want. You want to go to Falkreath?
Yes, we'll go to Falkreath and find more of these ruins with the dragon tomb on it. There are any, of course.
Okay. Seems just, you know, I'm actually kind of missing the action, guys. It's been kind of boring the past couple of days. Or at least today was boring. Aren't you guys... Isn't it weird not getting attacked by anything?
No, not really. It's actually
We're always
relaxing.
Getting attacked by things.
Quite relaxing,
Isn't
actually.
Isn't it strange to you that we're not getting attacked? Doesn't it seem like it's only a matter of time before we're going to get attacked by something?
I just don't want to cross the lake again. Wait, there was a bridge.
There was a bridge, yes, and we got attacked by crocodiles.
Never mind, I agree with Mev. Those crocodiles were fun. Let's go back to the dungeon.
Alright, and we're not. We're going to Falkreath, looking for something.
Let's get some rooms. We'll wake up in the morning and go to Falkreath then.
I'm awake.
Were we even sleeping?
Sorry, I was daydreaming.
What time is it?
It's like about midnight now, and you guys arrive in Wormsbirth. The caravan kind of sets up tents outside town to kind of sleep there. But do you guys want to go to the tavern?
No.
We'll stay with them.
Chill with the caravan.
Yeah. All
right.
Yep.
Yeah.
Yeah, you guys get a good night's sleep, feel a lot more comfortable now that you're like next to a town,
yep.
Or a village rather. And you, sun's up and the caravan starts to make its way towards Helgen, and I suppose you join it, of course?
Yep, yeah. All the way to Falkreath.
Yeah, the dude straight already paid you, so add 20 gold, whoever's managing that.
Got it.
I took my 5.
Yeah, if you guys want to do, if you do want to split it 5 ways, just...
I'm sick of being without money.
Fine, everyone gets 5 gold.
Okay.
Cool.
Everyone add 5 gold to your sheets. And yeah, you travel through the day. It's, you know, kind of quiet. The terrain changes from, like, the thick, almost dense forest to, like, almost a more rocky terrain. There's, you know, some mountains to either side of you as you travel. Just, like, in Wormsbirth itself, it's kind of, like, nestled inside a valley. After going through like a winding path, so you guys keep traveling through, and you know, you see kind of between two mountains, kind of closer to one of them, you see the walled city of Helgen before you as it becomes like afternoon.
This part of Skyrim is definitely different from the other part we were just in.
It's a big town.
Big walls.
Yeah, you see walls like 10, 15, at some parts 20 feet high towers. Adjourning them. You see taller buildings within the city itself. It's a much nicer place than a lot of other places you've been. It's like almost the size of Riften, but the gates seem even more impressive.
Wow.
So, the caravan then sets up outside of town as they do. Jihaji walks up to you and just like thanks you guys one more time. It was very good to have good business with you guys. And once again, if you need anything, you come to us. Look out for the Koshiva caravan.
Of course.
Great. Yep. Thank you.
You guys have more work?
Of course. It seems that, forgive me, but it may have been a little unnecessary to hire you, but you can never be too sure. And we do not always play based on chance. So.
No, of course not.
I'm sorry, I was daydreaming again.
You gotta stop that.
It seems you do that a lot.
I'm sorry.
But very well, everyone. Welcome to the Hold of Falkreath.
But we're in Falkreath or we're in Helgen?
Yeah.
The city of Helgen in the Hold of Falkreath.
Good save.
Learn your geography.
We're never in this part of
Skyrim. I only know trees, alright?
Only part of Skyrim that I've been in is Rift.
Yeah, you guys are now actually in the area you ever remember being in is Riften. And I don't think any of you guys have any history in Skyrim previously to that, do you?
Yeah, we've been in Morrowind the entire time.
Yeah, you guys have been like in other places and stuff doing other things. And now, you're in the area of Falkreath. And Helgen, it seems as you're talking to people, seems to be the main city here.
All right.
All right, now we're paladins. You guys wanted to come here, so what do we do now?
You guys want to catch me up on what we talked about? Because I didn't hear any of it.
You arrived at the city of Helgen. It's big walls, and the caravan thanks you. Everyone gets 5 gold.
Okay, and then what did we say before we went to sleep?
We're arguing about which way we wanted to go. Me and Tiger wanted to go back to the dungeon, and
I'm down to go back to the dungeon. I just wanted to get to Helgen.
Yeah, and now you've gotten there, so it's open.
Yeah,
to
our job's like fully over. I'm going to explore Helgen and then start.
But the job
back
was fully over.
No. The job was to go to Helgen.
Yeah, it was the original.
The job's whatever
destination.
The people paying us say the job is.
Nope.
Yeah. It could be
we signed up to go to Helgen.
Construed either way. Regardless, you're in Helgen now.
Cool.
A couple of the Khajiit and enter the gates open. They let you in if you would like to go in as well.
Yeah, let's go inside.
Well, I don't know if we're going to Falkreath or the dungeon. Regardless, I want to look around this town.
Yeah, well, yes. Around Helgen. We've never been here.
Yeah, let's do it. Maybe there's going to be some good shops or better armor, even though we just got better armor.
Make some acquaintances.
Yep, sure. Absolutely.
Where would you guys like to head? You're looking for some shops?
I guess we're just kind of exploring, looking at everything.
Yeah, I suppose.
Lechery.
Yeah, you walk by through the city, and you can tell it's definitely fortified. The keep is kind of in the center of town. It's all made of stonework. When you were in Riften, there was a lot of woodwork mixed into the buildings as well. But here, it's a lot of stonework. Everything looks almost like new in how it's been built up. And there's like arches going places. There's like an inner wall as well that cuts off part of the town. But it's separated into different districts. You guys are walking through the commercial district right now.
Mm.
So.
Oh, I wonder who's in charge around here.
Would be nice to get to know the Earl.
Yes. Also be kind of difficult.
A little presumptuous to think that the Earl would want to know us, don't you think?
Oh, nonsense. Look at us. We're obviously important travelers. We have two really distinguished paladins here, and,
let's just hope that there's no wizard you can talk to.
Maybe do I look around the town and see if there's, like, a keep anywhere?
Yeah, the keep is hard to miss. It's a, like, really nice stone, almost squared building right in the middle. This place is definitely set up, like, with very defensively.
Military.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a lot like, just to get the right picture in your mind, it's a lot like Helgen from Skyrim, except they built onto it. They repaired the walls, they added onto it. This place is looking stronger than ever.
Okay. Guys, I want to go talk to the
the who?
To the Jarl, whoever's in charge around here, the steward, whatever.
We could try.
Yeah,
so, sure.
There's no guarantee. So we go walk up to the keep and I bang on the door.
whoa.
Hey, respect.
I knock on the front door.
Yeah, guard opens up. He just does. He doesn't like, do any spooky stuff or anything. He just straight up opens the gate and is like, what business do you have here?
We have an appointment with the Jarl.
Oh my god. Do you?
No, we don't.
Mac, Mev on the back of the head.
Of course we do.
You must be the group of hunters that Yarlofina wanted to see. Sure, she's right in the long haul. Of course you can go right in.
Wait.
I whispered to Mev.
How did you do that?
Yes, Yarlofina.
I can be very convincing.
Is okay, she ignored? Yeah, thank you.
Yes, she is.
Oh.
Hmm.
Okay, so...
Okay, let's go.
I thought all you right. all knew this.
Yeah, oh, yeah, of course we did. Don't listen to my friends. They are idiots.
I have you for your memory help. Problems.
I'm you drunk, too. Sorry.
We're horrible people.
It's been a long journey. Anyway.
Yeah, you guys end up, you know, walking right into the heavy castle military establishment. No trouble.
Mev, you know you can't be doing that.
Let me talk to Vlado.
See, the thing about my character,
whisper to you, Leo, that both if anything you. Happens.
The thing about my character, Pandal, is
have my
he, can't he can't resist swindling people who are more powerful than him.
I'm gonna flirt with this girl while you watch.
That all right, nobody can fool me the way I can fool
talking
others.
Talking to both Fluffles and Vlado. Keep it cool, both of you. I know that you guys are trying to get
some. It's a female Jarl.
Have you never seen
he's a Nord.
Yes, and
Nord.
What's your point?
Nord.
Whoa,
Nord,
so
female Nord.
Were you a speciesist?
Or, yeah. I'm just down with the some Nords, you know?
Oh,
do you
oh,
even
oh.
know what a Nord is?
Her? Well, I'll tell you in a second.
obviously, you don't study enough.
Yeah.
Gordius made us study this stuff, man.
So what would I call this? What would her title be? Is she Jarl?
Yeah, they were referring to her as Jarl. And you guys find that strange because in Riften,
I kept
seems,
calling the Riften guy Jarl.
Yeah, the Riften that you kept assuming as a Jarl was referred to by everyone as the king. So
okay.
So disrespectful.
Yeah, like when you did mention Jarl in his presence, he definitely took note of it. So,
oh,
yeah, but this person, when you know, everyone you talked to, or at least the guard and the caravan guys you were talking to before, definitely referred to her as a Jarl. So,
okay,
keep in mind, dummies.
Yeah, you enter the long hall. There's a large wooden table set out there. There's not really much on it right now, except for, you know, a small fire basins just burning in the middle of it to give light. There's a lot of stonework going on. It's not really as ornate as some of the other castles, but the stonework is looking pretty solid. And at the end of the hall, you see a chair with before it Jarl Ulfina. And she
What's
is
she
a,
look like?
A 10 out of 10 pen. No.
10 out of 10?
No, it depends on if you are into them. She's a very sturdy looking Nord woman. She has, like, she's wearing a set of plate armor.
They have a
just
flat
in the hall.
Is like,
sounds like
she has kind of like a, almost a squarish
is it,
jaw.
Is it breastplate?
But yeah, straight metal. It's perfect.
Mm. Plato's down with that.
Oh God, Plato, keep it in your pants, please.
Yeah, she has blonde hair with like two braids going down the back of her head, almost coming down into like an Elsa braid in the front.
How old does she look like?
Maybe like 30, 40-ish.
Oh God.
Is Corvin with us, by the way?
Nah, Corvin's chilling out there with the Khajiit.
But you're into cougars, huh, Vlado?
Maybe not.
He's what's wrong? Cougars, I thought you would have been all in the Khajiit.
Does she address us when we enter the room, I guess? She's probably confused as to this strange group of people.
Yeah, you guys walk in and she just kind of has a puzzling look on her face but doesn't say anything as you approach. Anyone want to say anything before she does?
Hello, your highness.
Mev, go. Push Mev.
I'm just gonna stare at her.
Hello, it is a pleasure to meet your acquaintance.
Ah, yes, very good to see you. I thought there was only two of you.
Two of who now?
You are. Who are you?
Oh, I'm Mevinus. Nice to meet you.
The pleasure is all mine.
I noticed a lot of the people around here call you Jarl.
Yes,
you
of course,
like
I am
to anybody else.
Jarl of Folkreath. So
staring in her eyes still.
He being the Jarl. Yeah, and you see her eyes. She actually has like a scar on her face going down like the side of her lip. Her eyes are like a piercing kind of
Vlados is into that.
Like gray blue color.
Vlados into that.
Like it's
why Tyler? You know.
I didn't even intend that. Stop. We actually had a conversation about this last night, but that's what it is, man. That's what I have written down here, so.
Come on, Panda.
So I'll keep staring.
Gray eyes.
So, Jarl, you may be looking at us and wondering, what can I do for you? But the question is, what can we do for you?
Oh my god.
Just me and Fluffles both hold our head in our hands.
I'll just keep staring.
Well,
see, me and my associates here, we have a certain, let's say...
We have a particular set of skills.
Particular set of skills that might be... useful to somebody like you.
You're a great wordsmith.
Roll either a persuasion or deception check, your choice.
Hold on.
Whether you mean the skills you actually have, or if you're implying you have more skills. Your call.
We lying to her?
Damn it.
Oh, God.
Uh-oh.
We're gonna die.
Well, you all seem to have some weapons, but yeah. I do not know of you. How am I supposed to know of your skill?
Well, maybe you could give us a job. Let's call it a test of skill. Of course, you know, you'll pay us too.
That is a little presumptuous.
I don't think that's the right way to start off with any Jarl man.
Guys, let me do the talking.
I'm whispering to you. What are you...
Well, I was looking for mercenaries to help defend the borders here.
Mercenaries?
But I don't know. What are your skills you mention?
I shoot stuff.
He shoots stuff. And
then I take a shot into some, I don't know, something. What's around?
I guess
it's a lot of stone, so it's hard to think of. There, like, back in Riften, there was those wooden posts going up the sides of the room that, you know, the dude javelined.
It's good I got arcane arrows.
But yeah, it's a lot of stone there. Yeah, if you fire an arcane arrow, it might have a better chance of piercing it.
As a test of skill, alright?
Yeah.
What are you gonna shoot?
I don't know. That's what I'm asking. What's around? I'm looking around.
Let's just say...
Yeah, there's some banners on the wall with, like, the stag of the Falkreath sigil on there.
I shoot the stag in the eye. Let's do this.
Roll an attack. As you pull out your bow, two of the huskarls near here, like, draw their weapons, or at least, like, start pulling them out, and then just, like, see you kind of shoot. And they don't pull their weapons all the way out, but they, like, have them at the ready.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, you fire, and it hits the banner. It's not, like, a dead shot in the eye or something, but you hit the stag on it.
Okay, good. At least I don't look like a total loser.
Let's just say me and my friend, probably describe our general set of skills as beast slayers.
Well then, perhaps you will be able to help us out.
Kill cougars and a giant, if that means anything to you.
Yep.
A giant slayers? And I have not heard of you.
Mostly me, though.
Yeah, mostly getting us killed, almost.
Oh, well, I'm surprised you haven't heard of us. We're the best giant slayers out there.
I'm sure you are. How many giants have you slain?
One.
Countless.
Well, yeah, I guess.
You seem to have conflicting words here.
Well, did I not say let me do high, the so... talking?
I countless. Did...
I do not believe for one moment you have killed a single giant.
We have killed a single giant.
Yeah, but Mev rolled a 1 on his deception check.
Yeah, but like...
I thought I rolled a 6.
You rolled a natural one. You just happen to have a +5 when you lie to people.
Oh, right.
Well, regardless, anyway, you say you hunt beasts.
Yeah.
Hmm. Alright.
Problems around here?
What do you know of the Daedric deity of Hersine?
The what?
Hersine. At this moment, I stop staring, and I'm freaked out by her eyes.
I've heard of it in legend books.
That depends. Macintosh?
That depends. What can you tell us about the deity? Hersine
is the prince of the hunt, prince of the great game, the chase.
So you want us to take
Sounds
down
like
a
me.
Hunting deity?
Not the deity itself, that would be foolish, but a follower of him.
Hmm.
Okay.
You may more familiar know it as a werewolf.
A werewolf?
No, surely those kind of things don't exist here.
In the mountains?
We try not to have them exist here, but, you know, with all the business going on up north, it's hard to avoid.
Are they related to whooping goblins by any chance?
You've heard of the whooping goblins?
Yes, we've encountered some in Rift, actually, near Drakesville.
They are nothing. They are nothing.
All right, right now I'm just going to start stuttering.
I wouldn't exactly say they are nothing.
Plato?
If you find whooping goblins to be a problem, then you may not be helped here.
I don't find it to be a problem.
My name's Plato.
Blado. What is wrong with your friend here? First, you said you asked for you to do the talking.
I put my hand over his mouth.
He was dropped on his head as a small child.
Forgive me. I forgot my manners. If you would all introduce yourself, I am Yar Olfina.
Nice to meet you.
Can I?
I'm Mevinus. It's a pleasure.
Hold on. Before I go up to Panda. Later, I look him straight in the eye and I give him the two hardest slaps on both of the cheeks he's ever felt.
Can I fight him for this?
You're dazed.
Yeah, sure.
I'm ready to fight him for this.
Strength standard, you guys know what to do.
You're dazed.
Come at me.
Let's go.
I'm Darz.
Yeah, you, he does slap you, but you just straight take it. And you're like,
manly. I'm like,
boys, I'm sorry, Yarlafina. These are my associates, Flatos and Kratos, and, This is
Fluffles. Plato, Godius, and Kratos, Godius.
You have got it wrong.
They seem like capable warriors.
Kratos, yeah. Manicus, and Plato, Manicus.
I am a pretty good warrior.
They're idiots, though, too, at the same time.
I hear you Nords like that kind of thing, right? Warriors?
They're our friends, kids. They're kind of annoying.
It's so true.
At least I'm more rash than my brothers.
That's true.
That makes me nervous.
That's true. Anyway, so
your eyes scare me.
Where can this
how do we find these werewolves?
Wait, we're fighting werewolves?
Yes.
What?
We've been here. You've been here the whole time.
Werewolves, though?
You were looking into her eyes, weren't you?
No.
Don't lie to me.
I mean, I've never been up against one myself, but how bad can they be?
It's a werewolf.
It's a dog. They're all stupid.
Well, last
cat. Are you cats scared of
last
dogs?
One has been spotted here. It was in the ruins of old Folkreath.
Wait, ruins?
The ruins?
Yes.
That's interesting.
Wait, how long ago was the last full moon?
Hmm?
Werewolves come out during the full moons?
They come out whenever they please.
Oh, so these werewolves. Hmm.
Okay, well...
They are given many blessings by Ursine.
Oh boy.
Wait, so why are we hunting these werewolves?
Because she told
for
us
money?
To.
You don't have to. But they kill people.
What kind of
they kill people?
I kill people. I mean I what kill kind animals.
Of a,
I mean,
what kind of reward are we looking at?
We harm people to save others.
We get to meet her. That's enough of a reward for me.
What's wrong with you?
Well that's nice with you, but the rest of us actually want some monetary.
I'm doing it out of the goodness of my heart.
You know, being the experts that we are, our services don't
wait,
come
we've
cheap.
Never touched a werewolf before.
Shut up.
Got it.
I mean, what? We've slayed many werewolves before.
Put my mouth
but
no,
we have
not. I'll put
why
my hand
you
over your
this
mouth.
Beautiful
shut
woman.
Up.
My roll persuasion at disadvantage.
I could have later put my hand over his mouth. Oh.
That's not bad.
Yeah, she's not bad. She's kind of ignoring Plato at this time. Yeah, because yeah. You're just a bumbling fool at this point. So Mev seems to be like the responsible, persuasive one here. So,
I mean, obviously, you know, it's no problem for us, but it would be if we did not have these special skills. So, obviously, we don't come cheap. What kind of reward are you offering?
100 gold.
That sounds reasonable.
Wait, are there more than one out there?
Well, there could be.
Okay.
I hope so at this point.
And then how do we prove we killed these wolves?
Do we behead them?
You bring back the head.
That's what I thought.
We don't have to
That's
carry the whole
creepy.
Body, right?
Just the head.
We'll just take the head.
Okay, we got a deal. And then, you know, perhaps you'll give us more work in the future if you're happy with the outcome.
Yes, perhaps that could be arranged.
You know, maybe me and you, we could go to the inn and, you know, do a drinking contest. All right, Plato.
I don't think the Jarl hangs out at the inn.
So, do we have a deal? She, yes, like, takes off her heavily armored glove, like, undoes the buckle on it, and just, like, reaches, like, a muscular hand out towards you, Mephidus.
Yes. As Blados grabs it and kisses his hand.
What's wrong?
Of course we have
Yeah, what would you guys like to do with the hand stretched out in front of you?
I'm gonna go kiss it. I'm gonna go for a kiss on it.
I'm gonna hold you back and do the handshake myself before you get us into trouble.
We're all reaching for a hand and she's reaching for
Yes, Jarl, and I grab her hand. Of course we have a deal.
I'm assuming you're in front, Mephidus, so...
Yeah.
I'm trying to
shake your hand. She has a really strong grip that you aren't quite able to match. But
you feel okay? Of course we have a deal. You're no fine.
She doesn't like hurt you on purpose, but it's a strong grip, and you can't really do anything about it. So.
Looks at him puzzled.
Very good.
You have a woman.
I suppose we'll return with a werewolf head.
Yes.
No, we won't.
Looking forward. If
there are. Sorry about your banner, by the way.
Yes. You should be.
Why did you do that?
Big move, man.
I gotta show my skills. That's the best way I know.
Shooting a piece of paper?
So I guess we walk out of the room.
Yeah. You guys walk out.
Right. See, guys? I got us some work while we're here in Helgen. At least I did something useful.
So wait, now what do we do?
You didn't even want
to
be here.
Or do we go for the werewolf?
Yeah, I'm trying to
As you guys are exiting the keep,
lemons into lemonade.
You see, those bounty hunters that you ran into on the road before are actually arguing with a guard.
Oh, I'm gonna stare these guys down. Look, I'm being
playable.
Look, I'm
bolt straight. Why was this?
It was
stare these guys down.
Yeah,
me and Plato.
The orc has his helmet off and he's just like trying to look super intimidating to this guard. And he's just like, "Look, we were asked to come here. You can't just invite us here and then not let us in." And you guys fully catch. This happens.
Huh.
All of you quickly realize these were the guys who you just pretended to be.
I guess karma bites them really hard, huh?
I'm just gonna continue to stare.
You guys say anything or just like stare him down
I'm
as
just
you
staring
walk by?
The orc down.
I'll stare.
As we walk by.
No. I stop walking.
Hey, boys.
I'm just staring at him.
Look him in the eyes.
Yeah.
One of them looks at me, guys. And Julio pops
Plato,
out of nowhere.
Wink at one, I'll wink at the other.
What are you doing here?
I'll wink at the orc.
Orc just like turns away from the guard and just like turns his shoulder into him, bumping into the guard and just like slowly walks towards you guys.
Oh, hey, bud.
What's up? What's good, dude?
Hey, guys. How are you?
Shut up.
All in there.
Are you four taking contracts that aren't yours again?
What?
That sounds oddly familiar.
Who are these guys?
Karma quite bites you in the ass, doesn't it?
Whoa.
So what do they have you doing now?
Nothing.
Don't worry
about it. I just went in there and met with the Jarl, that's all. He likes me.
Don't concern yourself with it.
She likes me.
You jealous? She like me, not you, because you're ugly. Flato. She like me.
Oh, Flato, like that's me. Something. Okay,
Flato.
Okay. Yeah, that's right. That's right, she like me.
Anyway, it was good seeing you gentlemen again. It was not good seeing.
Don't lie to him.
We have work to do.
Don't lie to him.
So, hunting the wolves, huh?
We'll see.
What's a wolf?
Who said anything about that?
I mean, for
food,
yeah,
goblins,
sure.
The whooping
good
goblins.
Luck on your hunt.
We'll be fine.
Wow,
thank
why are you,
you
guys being so mean? They seem pretty polite.
Well, it's dangerous out there. Better keep an eye on your back.
Is that a threat?
It's dangerous out there. He's threatening us.
Guard. Okay.
We've been in more threatening situations.
The guard's just sitting there confused, like, did I make a mistake or did I... Are these guys going to all kill each other? I'm just going to sit back.
We appreciate the friendly warning.
I gripped the hammer really hard.
He also has his hand on his weapon as he just, like, smiles after issuing the threat.
Well, I'm going to wink at him.
We appreciate the friendly warning and we extend the same warning to you, of course.
All right, guys.
He just like sniffs and then starts like walking away.
Try and throw. Is he going towards the chamber?
Like he's just like not going back towards the keep now. He kind of like goes off in the opposite direction.
Now's your chance, Corbin. Shoot him.
No,
Corbin's not around right now. No,
just kidding.
Throw a rock at him, Dirk.
I don't have a rock.
And okay. A crossbow bolt flies through the air, through the sky. And
hey, guys! I was practicing my shots again.
And it soars past the orc's head, landing in an explosive barrel, killing you all.
Blowing them up.
Killing you all. Reroll characters. Get nerd! All right. Did we ever find out where? Okay, yeah. Where are those ruins?
I wasn't paying attention, if I'm being honest with you guys. I don't know what's going on.
Excuse me, Mr. Orc, do you know the way to fall?
Shut up!
Guys, keep it on the down low. We don't know where those two are.
Okay, true.
They sounded like they want to kill us.
Yeah, you guys open up your handy-dandy map of Skyrim, and,
Right, I'll say really loudly, just in case in the area.
On the map,
on the way towards Worm's Birth, they might be over there.
But didn't she say Old Falkreath?
Yeah, you guys, You ask around and you hear the tales of, the ruins of Old Falkreath. Once was actually the capital of this hold, but it was destroyed long ago.
Days! So depressing.
Yeah. But, you know, they rebuilt up Helgen, and it's the new capital, and they're doing good here.
Yeah.
Woo for Helgen!
All right, so we ready to head out to Old Falkreath?
Yes, we are.
See, I like how it went from you wanting to go to that dungeon so much to now wanting to go to Falkreath. Yeah,
who cares about learning dragon words of power that can help you, beat things? Yeah.
Maybe cool. Maybe there are ruins in Old Falkreath that'll help. You never know.
All right, so you guys start heading out to Old Falkreath.
Mm-hmm.
All right, the four of you head out and.
Corvin.
Yeah. Okay, that was a bait, but yeah, Corvin's with you.
Of course, Corvin's with us.
So like, where are we going now, guys?
We're going to
Don't worry about it.
We're going to fight a werewolf, buddy.
What?
Oh, God, he said it. Oh, God, he said it.
What?
That's what I say.
Like the big furry dudes with like the teeth?
It's like Fluffles here, but worse.
Also, guys, I don't know if... what time is it? Look up what time is it, DM?
Maybe right now sleep. It is actually it's like sunsetish right now.
Oh my
god, I don't know why I'm screaming so loud.
I guess we're going off to Falkreath to find the werewolves.
We could stay in town for the day and then go out tomorrow morning.
All right, later.
You think we're gonna find a werewolf at morning? In the daytime?
Yeah,
we get to leave at night, it'll be daytime.
If we live, yeah. No.
If we leave during the day, we'll get there at night.
Yeah. Well, isn't
don't
it...
you guys want to explore Helgen?
There's also
yeah, that's a really nice town.
There's also ruins in Old Falkreath that I would like to explore.
How could you possibly know there's ruins there?
We were just told.
When we were told about the ruins, it was the hold of Falkreath that was being mentioned, not the town.
So. Oh.
What that was stupid.
So you know there's probably more ruins like in this whole entire hold, but you don't know where anything is specifically. The only thing you have a hint about is the other thing, but you might find some. So
I would just like to do something, because so far we've traveled and talked to people.
All right, how about we go try and look for these ruins here? They'll help us like a lot.
Okay, so you head out to Old Falkreath to find a werewolf and some dragon ruins?
Yeah.
Aren't there anything in the hold?
Town?
Are we exploring Helgen first?
Yeah. Okay, what would you like to do in Helgen?
Yeah, we'll set out in the morning.
Okay. Yeah, next morning.
So before the night comes, you guys want to do anything in the town?
I guess we can look at the shops.
Blacksmith, Fletchery, or whatever it's called.
Yeah, look at all that stuff.
Yep.
Yeah. Get okay, just so we don't spend an hour haggling on prices when Mef clearly wants to get a fight in. I think everyone wants to get some fight in here, so.
Yeah, we are, out of character, we are having one of the more
Lato's the one who's always haggling on prices. I don't know for everybody else.
I feel like it's gone in
so anything specific though. You guys are looking for?
New bow? Better.
God dang, Tiger.
Alright, let's roll to see if the shops have any magic items or something. Because right now you got like a well-made longbow, so. It's a pretty solid weapon. Anything past that would be like some magic, but.
And I guess he's looking for a bigger quiver, too.
That's true.
Yeah. You do talk to the Fletcher there, and he says he can probably make you a bigger quiver.
Mm-hmm. This might take some time. How much? And how much time?
It says it might take him a few days, and the quiver would cost about 5 gold.
And how many arrows can that hold?
He's thinking like maybe 30.
Cool. I will give him my 5 gold and place the order, and we will return.
Alright.
I'll pick it up when I get my... when we get the werewolf.
Sure. Okay, so you got an order in for a large quiver.
Yay!
Alright, anyone else?
Anything you're looking for? No, not really.
Nope.
Alright, and daytime.
Yep, daytime. Everyone just like mark off. Or whoever's holding the gold, mark off 2 gold for everyone's rooms.
Okay, gotcha.
2 gold total.
Yep.
And, yeah, you head out to Old Falkreath. Corvin is happy that Cheryl can now go at a brisk pace once again. Right, as she was destined to do.
Let's go!
And, yeah, you guys travel through. You see more of that that less familiar mountainous terrain. It's definitely, like, more rocky here rather than, like, forest and hilly. Past through, you see some of the peaks have, like, some snow on them, but it's not snowy here, so. Yeah, you manage to go through without too much trouble. And, yeah, you reach Old Falkreath kind of, like, afternoonish. You expected you would get there later in the day, but it's just kind of news. So, yeah, you guys see it. It's definitely just, like... it's completely abandoned. There's just, like, buildings blasted apart. It's almost like Beggar's Rest, but, like, ooh, bigger. And there's just, like, one big set of just, like, a stone foundation in the middle where there was a long hall, but it's just nothing there anymore except just, like, rubble and a... it's just, yeah, covered in, like, it's half covered in, like, moss and grass now. It looks and like you... whatever happened here happened a long time ago.
Any ruins?
No obvious ruins that you would, see. I mean, if you want to, like, go to a high place and do a perception check, then you have a chance of finding some.
I'm looking out for these ruins, man.
Okay. So, right. Yeah, you find a, once you do get to a good place in your searches, make a perception check. Yeah, you don't particularly find anything that's obvious. You see, like, some interesting looking, might be a structure in the mountains, like it's a shaded area. You see, like, when you look in the distance, you see what might be like a lake to the north, and just a few other things, but nothing obvious.
Think here, nothing in the proximity anyway. Guys,
see anything? No.
I guess should we each do an investigation check to see if we see anything out of the ordinary?
Sure.
Investigation or perception?
Investigation if you're looking around for werewolf tracks or anything like that.
Well, I didn't find nothing.
I know.
Yeah, Mevidus, you're looking around and you can definitely find there's been some movement here lately, but it seems like if anything it's just like, you know, people have maybe like camped here when they were passing by. It doesn't look like there's no like clumps of fur and blood anywhere, if that's what you're looking for.
Yeah.
Okay. Nothing obvious.
Okay, well, if I remember werewolves correctly, let's just hope that we can find some people and get them out of the way as quickly as possible.
Well, it's a ruins of a town, and I think it's a. There's not any people around, right?
The werewolves are
yeah,
around.
Yeah, there's no
this
one
area.
Here right now.
Yeah.
It's husk of a city, really.
But if there are werewolves around, and if I know something. Do I know something about werewolves?
I don't know, do you?
I don't know. What do I roll?
Let's history? See. What are you trying to think? Like, history of werewolves?
Yeah, like...
trying to draw on, like, knowledge of her sign?
More or less of how the werewolves Okay, yeah, make a form, I guess.
Yeah, I'd say history check.
Yeah.
Yeah, you actually recall a book that you read.
Yeah. So, guys, if we find any humans or people around, we might want to finish them off as quickly as possible.
That's not very paladin-ish.
Well, these... Well, werewolves turn... Why would she...
I don't know. I mean, Vlado came on kind of strong there. Maybe,
Vlado came on strong.
I mean, did we?
Yeah, but
what about you, Lionic Lyerson?
Yeah, deceiving man. You should be the last one to talk about deceiving people.
Hey, I'm just trying to get us work. I'm trying to make the best out of our situation.
I'm trying to get on this.
Vlado just wanted to go sightseeing in Helgen. I'm trying to actually do something.
Julio, don't look at me like that. Whatever his name is.
Name's Julio. You got it.
Okay. Alright, I just don't remember.
Don't talk to my snake like that, though.
He's looking at me funny.
Thinks you're cute.
Anyway, ooh. So...
Cold over here. He's cold.
Now what, okay. Guys?
Well, I guess we might as well wait it out till nighttime. I didn't expect to get here so early.
I don't know, is there any buildings around or anything? Let's look around, let's see what we can find.
Yeah, well, let's look in this old long hall.
Well, I already did an investigation.
Just look around, there's still some buildings that you could definitely, you know, take some cover in, stuff like that.
Yeah.
If you would like to do that.
Okay. Hey, Corbin, you want to work on your target practice?
Sure. What should I shoot at?
Later.
Vlado.
No, not Vlado.
I don't think I should do that.
He'll never hit him.
Are we in the type of terrain where there would be like a tree around somewhere?
Yeah, there's just even some building chunks that you could aim at. Plenty of targets.
Ooh, how about, see that pillar that's coming out of that building? Shoot at that.
Hey, aim at the snake.
I know it's pretty far away, but you got this.
Aim at the snake.
How far away is it?
Without hesitation.
It's about...
Kind of cold, don't you think?
60 feet at this point.
60 feet, okay. Bang! Nailed it.
Nice.
Wow!
Bounces off the pillar, but hey, he hits it.
Corbin, you are a natural.
I like now, to think
Mev,
so.
Mev, do the same thing, why don't you?
Oh, me? Yeah. Okay, fine.
Oh, boy.
With my arrow, let's see here.
Are you sure that's how you do it?
No, Corbin, look, here, this is how you do
I'm
it,
trying
right?
To shoot him.
I got you.
You still hit it.
Got you. But...
Julio tripped me up.
Kratos, you miss.
Oh, not as badly as Mev.
Yeah, I'm just showing him the extreme of how not to do it.
Obviously, out of all of us, Fluffle
have you been trying
be
to show us the extreme every time we get into a fight, then, too, with that rapier?
Yes, that's...
Whoa. Okay, that's fine.
Pretty... Yeah, I mean...
I'm legitimately curious.
He brings up a point.
Fluffles, keep up your sass, and I might have to unleash a bit of a charm spell on you. Make
if
you into a nicer
it.
Guy.
Hmm.
Anyway.
You couldn't hit the broadside of a barn with a charm spell.
I'm gonna take another shot.
Okay.
He fires and...
Oh!
Ching! This one sinks right into the, between two cracks in the, you know, bricks on the pillar.
Yeah, it's Corbin, you're a natural. Corbin.
You're a natural.
Cool!
Luffles, take him out before he becomes a threat.
Gotcha.
What? What? Who said that?
All right, so as you guys continue
I'm on it.
Bantering and practicing, you want to make
kidding.
That a secret hunted mine?
No.
Okay. Yeah, the sun comes down, and you guys are keeping a heavy lookout for anything?
Yep.
All right. So, yeah, I guess you're all looking outside. We'll make a perception check.
Isn't it night? So is everybody at this?
Yeah, I guess they would be at disadvantage. It's just like just becoming night, so.
Man, my perception has just been really bad lately.
Yeah, but Vlado and Fluffles, you actually do see there's a man kind of walking up. Yeah,
I didn't see. Oh, because I'm at
wait,
this
what
advantage.
Am I seeing? Mine's just as good as Panda's is.
Yeah, you guys are.
What did I see? It.
No, you saw it. It was me and
but
you.
Yeah. And then Kratos, when they pointed out, you see it too. Mev, not so much.
Oh, I thought it was Kratos.
It's dark.
Later, wait, what did I see?
It is me. Hi, how are you?
Yeah. You guys see, like, a old, kind of like an old man, with, like, a ragged cloak walking up.
Oh, God. All right, guys, you ready?
What do you guys see?
It's a person.
You can see it. After
he starts to approach you guys.
Hey, like, what's up, dude?
Guys, be ready for
he's
a fight.
He's still, like, 100 feet out. You guys spotted him pretty
early. Hey, what's up, dude?
Don't call him this way.
He's already walking towards us.
Yeah, yeah, he, kind of keeps walking. Towards you.
All right, guys. Can I shield of faith myself now?
Sure.
Yeah, I'm gonna do the same thing.
I will give him a preemptive hunter's mark, however, just in case, without telling anybody.
I'm gonna shield of faith too.
Make a sleight of hand check if you want it to be sneaky, sneaky.
I didn't realize there was any hand movements involved with my hunter's mark.
You say something, I think, when you hunter's mark stuff. So.
Can he just whisper?
Yeah, he can. Like, he can try to hide it. He doesn't do a very good job.
He's 100 feet away.
Yeah.
Oh, he's 100 feet away.
But it's also like a magical spell. Like, this guy can kind of tell. So. He, like, kind of stops for a second, but then keeps walking towards you.
Hmm.
Damn, like a lot of bull pucky.
Alright, guys, be
he's
ready
about
for
60
a
feet out right now.
Alright, guys.
Oh, I'm scared.
Wolves in human feet form out. Usually have the cloak. Be ready.
Hey, Corbin, you got that these crossbow wrecks ready?
Sure, but he's just an old man.
Stay behind us, guys. Stay behind us.
Just prep it.
Okay.
We've met some dangerous people who also
40 feet out.
All right, guys. You guys all stay behind me and Kratos. Let us take
maybe
the
I should do the talking.
I don't
you
think
you
would
want
to in
but
this situation.
Stay behind us.
Almost nighttime.
Okay, maybe are Kratos and Vlados, you guys aren't like shoulder to shoulder, right? You're just like, there's a bit of a space in between
you when
you're
standing. There's a little
bit of a
space, not much, but
so I'm kind of standing in between you guys, but back a step or two.
Yeah. The music's getting all intense.
30 feet
and
out.
I guess as he's approaching at this point.
We're in Drakesville. How'd that
good
happen?
Evening, traveler. How can we help you tonight?
Do you have any food?
Wait, where is he? He's not on the map yet.
Yeah, let me.
Of course we have food.
Yeah, I just switched it over to this map. Let me switch it over here for
I'm just going
to
put everybody into their spots.
We got Plato if you want to eat him.
Yeah,
what
sure.
More?
Organize yourself.
We have some food. Who's asking?
My name is Darwald.
Darwald.
I like his name.
Do we have our weapons drawn or no?
What is an older man?
Yes.
What
we
is
do.
An older
I said
man
get ready.
Like you doing traveling
oh, yeah,
by
so
yourself
a,
at
not
night like this?
Sides, though.
Well, I only just made it here. Need somewhere to sleep.
Okay, where are you
not
traveling from?
Just I wander here and there.
Why do you wander? Tip man.
Nowhere else
we
to go,
wander?
I suppose. And he just keeps walking towards you.
We don't
can
live
you,
anywhere.
Can you stop walking towards us?
Keep your distance.
Wow, you guys are defensive.
Let me get an actual thing for you guys on here.
Wherever
I don't
you
like
are.
It when people keep walking towards me like that.
Especially people we don't
oddly
know.
Oddly suspicious of
halt!
A random person.
Thought I told you about
work.
This.
I believe that's close enough, friend.
Oh, please, I just need a bit of food.
I yes. Go up to him and hand him some food.
No, Tiger.
Where is he?
I feel
Tiger
bad.
Tiger never listens
to I have to use this
us.
Really fat guy, so.
Okay. Oh, he's the other way.
Yeah, he's the other
oh,
way.
Oh, he's over here.
Where is he? Oh, God.
Up there.
Oh.
See, what was he like? 30, 20 feet out? So.
I guess Meb just sit there.
Yeah, he'll be about there, so.
I secretly told Julio, though,
and that's
if anything
Corbin
goes
standing
down,
behind me.
Constrict him.
Is this Corvin?
We have
only command already.
Back there. Actually, no, forget this Corvin. Let's get the new Corvin out there.
Are you Corvin?
Let's get yes. The real
I'm excited.
Corvin out there.
I really want to know what Corvin looks like.
Julio's like. Hidden-ish, wrapped around me. Oh my god!
That is
yes. Exactly how I imagined him.
Let me just make sure it's coming up on the stream.
Oh my god.
Yep, that is Corvin and Cheryl.
He's humongous right now.
Yeah, I know. I just
yeah,
wanted to
so
make the picture clear. But yeah.
Oh, legend.
That's amazing.
Mm.
Corvin.
Cheryl is beautiful.
He's the greatest. Okay.
I don't like this guy. He's creepy.
Yeah, so. Tiger, you walk up to him. What do you hand him? Some of your rations?
Julio's on command, though. If anything goes down.
Yeah, he sees the large snake wrapped around your shoulders and is like, ugh. Nice pet.
Thanks. I like him. And then I hand him some rations. I don't know what we got in our bags. Probably some bread or some crap. But here you go.
Yeah, yeah. You have a lot of like dried rations, like Lembus dried bread. Meats, some bread that'll keep. Lembus bread. All Lembus bread. Yeah, he takes some and just like starts eating it a little bit.
What do we do, guys? You think this werewolf's ever gonna show up? I'm kind of tired.
Hold on.
Does that spark the old man to say anything about like
werewolves? There's no werewolves around here.
Where's? Can I see the moon?
Oh, really? That's not
yeah. You see slowly the moon starts to crest over the horizon.
Guys, get ready. Just in case, you never know.
So he just eats the food and says, "Do you have any water to go with it?"
Of course I do. Here you go.
Hand him the water skin.
Back up.
He takes a reasonable sip. He doesn't like steal all your water or anything.
He's polite about it. I respect that.
He gulps it down, throws your water skin on the ground,
turns into a werewolf,
and stomps on your water skin,
like in rock in the night form.
Thank you very much.
Of course, I understand how hard it is to be hungry.
Well, it's dangerous for an old man to be out here alone. Wow. Would you like to make camp with us for the evening?
What are you doing?
Oh, I suppose that would be reasonable. I was going to just find a building here, but that would be wonderful. Thank you.
Yeah, absolutely.
Don't trust this guy.
What's not to trust? He's just a nice old man.
That just trust wanders old around.
So yeah, as you guys have this epic standoff with a old man chowing down on some Lembus bread. Anyone doing anything?
Looking out for some suspicious werewolf.
I'm going to introduce him to Julio.
Okay.
This is my pet snake. He is awesome, but don't mess with him.
Alright, let's see. He reaches out his hand, and how do you think Julio would react?
I think he licks him.
Okay. Forked tongue just licks across his hand. Two seem to be friendly enough with each other.
Gives him kisses.
Best of snake kisses.
Oh, stop that. Don't do that. No, that's that.
Okay.
Alright, so you guys make camp and let your guard down?
I'm not letting my guard down. I'm nervous, dude. I don't trust this guy for a second.
I'm ready, but I'm not necessarily suspicious. Still smart about it, though.
Yeah. Okay. So yeah, he kind of follows your guys' lead to wherever you may be setting up camp.
Probably in a building, yeah.
Sure. Do we want to have a fire or?
Yeah, I guess.
Okay. So you get supplies for fire? No,
we're gonna go in a closed building with this guy?
No.
Then let's be outside. I don't care.
I'll be outside.
I'll be outside as well.
Don't not make a suggestion then instantly knock down my suggestion. When you're asked. Like, come on, dude.
Yeah, okay. So he kinda follows to the group. Hey, guys.
Alright, I guess we'll make camp kind of here at the intersection of the town.
I'm just gonna back up.
Okay, just like kind of right in the middle of it.
Keep my eyes on this guy.
Sure.
Hey, we got a fire going, so we're right. Here.
Stop.
Yeah, but yeah. He just joins. He seems to be friendly enough.
I don't trust him.
I keep my eye on the moon.
I just keep looking at him.
Yeah, the moon is definitely showing in the sky now.
I'm kind of just staring at the fire.
The sun is down,
drone,
the fire is
humming lit. A little tune.
So when you want to go off and try to hunt some meat?
Alright,
so where's everyone sitting around this fire?
Alright, where's the fire at?
Let's see, let's get the paintbrush out. Fire, right there.
Okay, so me and Duck are going to be next to each other. Wait, where's this guy? Hold on, that's going to determine everything. Where is he?
He's going to sit down depending on how you guys are sitting down.
Oh, no, I got to watch him.
All right, well, you take a seat.
I'm just going to stand up until he sits down.
First of all,
Corvin's going to chill here next to these guys. He's probably going to chill here.
Yeah, I guess I'll
Corvin, sit here. High five, buddy. High five.
Oh, you guys are rude.
That's my arm.
I'll sit over here.
Alright.
Feel bad for this old dude.
And you guys are like sitting back 5 feet away from the fire.
Grandpa Fluffles.
Yep.
Okay.
So what did you say your name was again, traveler?
It is, Jerick.
Oh, Derek, okay. Well,
Derek?
Jerick.
Where have you, where are you coming from?
As I said, I kind of just wander. I came from the north.
You wander the woods?
The paths.
These aren't woods.
Wherever the road takes me.
There's woods everywhere.
Do you not have a forest?
Oh, my home is... where is it? You see where the peak back there reaches the horizon?
I'm not looking.
You stare at him as he points it out.
I'm staring at this guy, dude.
Yeah, because he's pointing like over your shoulder, essentially.
I don't trust him for a second.
Okay, so you guys are both just standing there staring at him as the other guys look.
Oh, I see.
Oh, yeah, that peak back there.
Right over that area is a village that I'm from, but I haven't been there in months.
Is there anything, is there like any thing he's wearing that points to his religion or some following, whatever?
Let's see. I guess you can decide to make a, what kind of check would that be?
Would it be investigation?
It would be either an insight or a perception check. Because you're not, like, looking through him. So.
I'll do insight.
Yeah, insight, you're just kind of seeing if he's giving anything off. Yeah, this dude seems shifty. Something seems to be wrong here. In fact, Kratos, you realize he gave you two different names.
He did give us two different names.
He gave me a different name.
You say that out loud?
Don't say anything yet. Don't say anything.
I'll just whisper it to Plato.
I know.
Give us a different name.
Do I see anything on him?
Yeah, you don't see anything, like, too incriminating. It just looks like a
just old
man with
clothes.
Yeah, basic materials.
Are they torn?
They're, like, torn at places. It's not, like, straight Hulk torn mode, though.
Okay.
What's your thing, Derek? What are you all about?
Well...
Those people.
I suppose this is only, gonna be the hard way.
What do you mean, the hard way?
It's a lovely night.
Ready, Kratos?
Guys,
ready?
I told you.
Ready?
And yes. As you guys stare at him, you see his form start to just like twist and turn as just like not only the fur starts growing, but muscles start rippling out. The robes do come off in Hulk mode. As his back just arches, like bones start to just like extrude from where his spine is, poking out like almost 2 inches at certain spots, and this guy grows to like 7 feet tall. His fingers extend into just like jagged claws, and his like dark brown fur just looks mangled, and you see just like a curled
grin. I'm guessing we can't charge him while he does this, can we?
How big is he as a werewolf? Because I know they can either
he's
be
7 foot.
Yeah, he just said about 7 feet.
He's probably about the size of a bear.
Okay. This should be fun, then.
I guess.
Yeah, he would still be considered, like, he wouldn't be, like, a larger size than you guys in D&D terms.
And me and Tiger obviously just moved
he's
back.
Just a foot
I imagine we
you.
Would all have
yeah,
had
you
an
got
opportunity
a chance. To... Yeah, I'd say you can have that.
Julio was on constrict when things get a little fuzzy, though.
Yep, so,
it's cold that happens.
Yeah,
here.
Let's roll some initiative right here.
Okay.
Where's my guy? Boom shakalaka.
So more importantly, we gotta get
we
some
got that
fancy turn. Music.
Yep.
Let's try this.
We need some werewolf fighting music.
Oh my
That's
God.
Not werewolf fighting music. Let's see. Let's go with one of the dependable ones there. There we go. Never can go wrong
with
this one.
Oh snap.
Roll for right. Corbin.
Oh yeah, I'll roll for Corbin. Let me get my two characters open here. All right. The
Derek,
initiative.
I had better hopes
werewolf
for you.
Werewolf rolls 16.
Jesus, so
you guys
first.
Didn't realize you gave two different names?
Let's see.
I guess not.
Corvin rolls an 8.
Oh, so he's moving with Mev.
So, yeah. It looks like Werewolf Man is going first.
This could be Mev and Tiger, and then, or no,
I go
Corbin and Mev.
I rolled an 11.
It's Tiger.
He rolled a 16.
Yeah, luckily it went up.
I thought Mev rolled an 8.
Oh, did you roll an 11 there?
Sorry. Yeah.
Okay. Sure. And then two nines and an eight. Okay, everyone else is up there aside from Tiger. So. Sure. So let's see if we have any cool werewolf images here.
Oh no.
Oh yes, we do.
God damn it.
All right.
I knew we should have struck down this old man.
So did I.
But imagine if you were wrong.
That would have been so heartbreaking. My character would never have been able to live with himself.
What's this?
That's gonna be him.
I had high hopes for Derek.
Oh, I thought he was another one.
Jarek! Or whatever his other name was that I made up on the spot without looking at my list.
Derek to me.
Did Jarek right after you.
Yeah, I don't remember the other name you said, but it definitely wasn't Jarek.
It wasn't at all.
I recognized something with it. I'm like, maybe he's not just messed up.
So, did Julio get him?
Unfortunately, Julio's going to get his attack in on your turn. But he will get to attack without you having to make another command.
Okay.
Okay, so let's me see what this werewolf can do. Alright, he turns into that wolf, and now let's see what he can do.
Are you sure he doesn't want to take a break?
Is Corvin
like
back
that?
Out?
Yeah, Corvin backs up with you guys. He's kind of right there.
Where's Cheryl during
all this? Cheryl's, you know, tucked away probably against the building.
Okay.
Yeah, with
you get the impression she's not going to be his first target, so. Yeah, he is going to go rushing towards my Fluffles, because...
Wow, I was kind of messed up.
He checked it. Yeah, while you were doing that, he was checking out your armor and seeing that you're the most lightly armored here, so. He is going to bite at you.
Oh no.
Yes.
Yeah, and he's going to, as you jump back from his bite, he then reaches out with his lanky arm and just goes to claw at you.
Oh my god.
Alright.
Derek, you jerk.
You take 7 points of slashing damage.
Woo!
Should've never fed you.
Alright, but that is his move. So as he does that, he slashes out at you. Then Julio crawls up his arm and begins to try to wrap around him. Roll the constrict attack.
Okay.
Oh, my god.
He kind of shakes him off as he pulls his arm back from the slash.
Oh, fine. It's time to wreck this guy.
That is a hit with the first one. All right, you deal... Yeah, you did Hunter's Mark him, so he is still unmarked.
That what the four is?
I think it is.
No, that's the... Oh, no, it's not.
No, no. Yeah, four is the Hunter's Mark, right?
It doesn't say Hunter's Mark under it.
I think last time
I'm pretty sure that's what it is, though.
It's probably what it is, so yeah. Just go
okay.
First one.
He proceeds to take some damage.
Oh, God. Wait... Dark, I think
he's
I know what we gotta do.
Undead, is he?
I don't think that's what we have to do in this scenario.
No, he is not classed as undead, I don't think. No, he is not.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not sure.
Yeah. You would kind of recognize that since your favorite enemy is undead. Yeah, normally, I think I have the Daedric list up here. You are against the Daedric Prince. I don't know which one, but there's a different one that's more into undead, and this one is definitely a follow of her sign, as the paladins would recognize. Okay, so who's up next? Paladins?
Us, yep. Alright, you go first, Plato.
You moving up with me? We could do our turn at the same time. We have the same number.
Yeah, do whatever you would like.
Hey, come with me. Move up here.
Cool.
Okay.
Alright,
I guess I'm gonna battle axe. He's gonna do
Warhammer.
Alright, two weapons come swinging. He ducks out of the way as they actually clash into each other as you swing at the same time.
Oh, that hurt. Ugh. You guys are useless.
Okay, anything else, guys? You still have your bonus.
What can we do with a bonus?
I don't know if you Shield of Faith, did you?
I did.
Yeah, we both did.
Okay,
you
both did? Okay.
Yeah, alright, we're done here.
Can I guess we just prepare like our shields?
Yeah, you can just be ready to block. It's not really a bonus action, but for role.
I'm actually not really know what else to do.
Oh, before we end, I'll move right there, just in case.
Okay. Kind of put yourself between him and Mevidus.
Yep.
Speaking of which, Mevidus, I'll let you go first, then Corbin.
Okay. I am... What should I do here? I guess I'm just going to shoot my short bow at him right now.
Okay. Yeah, you have a clear enough shot.
I'm guessing charm person and everything won't work on him.
Ooh, I could try.
Mev lands a shot.
I wouldn't.
For five. For some damage.
Alright, now we hope Corbin doesn't shoot dark in the back of the head.
Yeah, the arrow just like pierces into him, but like he keeps on pushing. Like
Yeah, he's probably gonna push.
He's getting ready to launch out, reach out for another attack. So Corbin is now going to move over to here and prepare his crossbow and fire a shot. Oh! Nope. Not hitting any of you, but
okay.
It lands by Vlado's feet. So
I
quickly looked down at it.
Corbin.
I don't say anything. I just look down and look right back up.
The two paladins aren't gonna get hit regardless, so I don't like. I'm just scared of Julio getting a freaking.
Yeah, let's see. Let's see. Yeah, I guess both Tiger and Mev fit him, so he's gonna continue going for Tiger.
Oh, great.
Reaction.
Alright, you use your reaction. Yep. Claws at you.
Ooh.
Good thing that reaction. Hit. Actually, no, it still hits. It's 2 16s.
Well, you reactioned anyway, so.
Yeah, the reaction makes it gives it disadvantage.
Oh! Yeah. Oh!
Yeah, he rolled
so that means it takes the lower of the two numbers, but that's an armor class. He deals 4 points of damage to you with the worst possible roll he could make on that attack. So. That's good for you guys. And then he's going to, as he claws at you and kind of like sinks in, he's going to use the momentum of it to reach in and try to bite at your shoulder.
Oh, man.
Oh, my God.
Gotta hit
me. Leave me alone, Derek.
6 more points of damage. And, this is why you don't feed old people. Throw.
Come on, Derek.
Throw.
This is
all that stuff
is
straight up
there
in front of
you. Feed me, actually.
Yeah, make
sorry?
DC 12 constitution saving throw.
I don't like what that looks says.
This one?
Yep.
Or?
That's the one.
Oh
well,
my God.
That's not your saving throw, but
it's
good enough, so.
Okay.
So yeah, you feel definitely something, but you just like shrug it off as you get like slightly dizzy. But now you can retaliate.
Like, you better kill this guy.
In one
you
shot.
Fed him. You fed him.
You better one shot him.
Yeah, his jaws are like locked around your shoulder right now.
Well, Julio's going in for the constrict again, obviously.
This time Julio goes to wrap around his legs, seeing if that'll be any better chance, and does not manage to. He kicks him off.
And Julio, you're useless.
Mr. Watts?
I disengage.
Okay, yeah. So you push him off you.
1, 2, 3.
And get around there.
4, I go up to Corbin.
Okay.
Julio follows suit.
Yep, he howls into the night.
Actually, no, Julio.
Make do with what I got. Okay. And yeah, he kind of like growls at you as you run
wait,
off.
Wait, I have a bonus action?
You do.
Oh wait, Cure Wounds is a regular action.
Yeah, I don't know if there's much you can do aside from Hunter's Mark.
Nope.
Okay. Paladins, you're up. He just turned towards you guys as...
That's good.
Alright, let's hit him with the combo, brother.
Come on.
Alright, you guys swing. He like ducks out of the way as Vlado swings towards him, but that brings him right into the Warhammer hit as you smack him right
purpose.
Across the chest. Alright. Yeah, you guys seem to be connecting with him, but he is not showing it. So.
Bad.
Alright, Mevidus.
Okay. Seeing that Fluffles has taken some damage.
Oh, Corvin fires a crossbow, Corvin. And this thing just like kind of like pierces right through some of the flesh in his neck.
Ah!
And yeah,
Corvin natural 20.
Just rolled again. A natural 20 with his +1.
Okay, so I guess now I go.
Why is Corvin such a champ? Yeah.
So I cast healing word on Tiger.
Thanks, bro.
Okay, yeah. So that's your bonus action.
Oh, is it?
Yeah, healing word's a bonus.
I didn't know
Cure
that.
Wounds is slightly stronger, but it's a regular action and you have to touch. Healing word is a range and it's a bonus action.
What is going on? Okay, sorry. That's just weird. Okay, then I can still attack.
Yeah.
Alright, I guess, I attempt. Just to see if it works to cast Charm Person.
You can't really use another spell. But You can go next. It's just you get like an attack action as well.
Oh, okay.
I'm kind of going to back up.
Me?
Yeah, I don't know if I'd stand. Oh, I guess you're safe.
Yeah, unless I hit him and anger him again.
Nah, he is dark in the way.
Yeah, okay.
Kind of, I guess. It's up to you.
I am going to once again shoot my short bow at him.
Alright, that hits.
Okay. Doing 7 piercing damage.
Okay. Yeah, another arrow sinks into him. He just like reaches and breaks it off.
Why do I feel like
and he like pulls
this...
the arrow that Corvin took as well, and he's like still holding those arrows as he goes and tries to like leap over Kratos. That'll prompt an attack of opportunity from Vlado.
Okay. Yeah.
What about me? No.
No, you're still in range with him. Yeah, that's a hit.
Roll damage. Oh, he's going this way. Okay.
All right. Yeah, and he's just leaping at Mephidus right now, and he goes like. He's using his claws, but he's like kind of trying to shove the arrows into you with 2 claw attacks.
Oh dear! Oh,
ooh,
that's a hit for.
8 I'm reactioning damage. To bite.
All right, he's actually going for 2 claw attacks, but you'll reaction a second. So.
Oh, I thought he was gonna. Ooh.
Yeah, 13 misses with your new armor, so.
Yeah, so I took 8.
Yeah, you took 8 points of slashing damage.
Okay.
Okay, that's his turn. Fluffles. Hit him.
Alright. Time, boys. The damage is coming.
Right,
the
Julio can continue to go at him and try to constrict again.
Yes, and he will do so. Let's go, Julio.
He manages to wrap around his legs and constrict him.
Alright. Now it's time, boys. Sharpshooter. Ryuga Wagateki Wokuro!
Sharpshooter, that's a miss.
Oh,
okay.
Nice.
I tried.
He built it up, he hyped it up.
It was so
hyped.
Right?
Paladins.
What the brother's gonna do?
I guess I first have to move up.
Okay.
And then...
He growls and sneers at you.
I don't care what he says to me. He's ugly.
I'm gonna...
I accidentally rolled the damage for you, but I'll let you roll it.
And his first hit.
Thank
better.
I get the attack of opportunity.
Yeah. He did.
The attack of opportunity.
Alright, yeah. You guys deal a good amount of damage to him this round. Okay.
Ugh.
Is that max damage on both your weapons? Ah, no. Close, though. It's max for dark.
Yeah, mine's 11. Yep. I was one off. Right.
Okay.
All right. Good work, brother.
Alright.
Oh, yeah, I didn't roll the constrict damage.
Yeah, go ahead and roll that. What's the... I don't think
oh,
the roll's
God,
still
I don't
working.
Remember
but...
how to do this. Yeah,
Okay. Yeah, it's not gonna work.
Okay. Oh yeah, 1d8 plus 2, that's what it was.
Okay. Go ahead, roll that damage.
That's just as good as my weapon. Actually, mine's 1d8 plus 3.
Okay, buddy. Yeah, he constricts into his legs. Corvin's not gonna fire another arrow. Mevidus, you're up as well.
Okay.
Another bolt, rather. Nope.
Now, I guess I'm going to attempt Charm Person to see if it works.
You might want to disengage and back up.
I don't think you could charm after that.
Can
yeah,
I disengage?
It's bonus, isn't it?
No, Charm's an action.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay.
But I was like, I don't think you could do that.
Alright.
I'm gonna, try to hit him with Charm Person.
Alright, and you're...
Humanoid.
Oh, what's a humanoid? Does that count?
I don't think so.
No?
Do you want to cast it?
Well, werewolf is a humanoid. I think.
Yeah.
Is he a,
either way, yeah, I guess I'll cast it.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess we'll figure out.
It doesn't seem to affect him.
Okay.
It figured as much.
Where did he get all this wisdom, bro? Oh, it's just a good roll.
I'm also
by rolling a 19, that's where.
I think pretty conscious of what he was going to do.
I am going to also cast Bardic Inspiration on Kratos.
Hey.
Okay.
Cast it on me.
How do you inspire Kratos?
My bow.
Awkwardly in the middle of this whole battle, I turn to Kratos and just start singing him a sweet song. Kratos, the way of a Hackintosh will guide you. And he's like, dude, shut up. But still,
I still feel
strangely
inspired
by it.
Yeah. All
right, yeah,
he's got it stuck in his
D6
head.
Inspiration die to use whenever you please.
Yep.
Okay, looks like he is going to,
Kratos, you're the one!
Alright, we get it.
He's gonna try to stop this singing real quick. And he's gonna lunge at Mevidus.
With a bite?
Let's see, he's kind of doing both the attacks at once. I'm gonna put down what I, order the attacks. Which one do you want to try to block? One or two?
Oh,
two playing us.
Yeah!
No!
All right. Ooh, okay. Deals 4 points of damage, and Mev, make a Constitution saving throw.
Please.
Okay.
And now the claws. Nothing.
Oh, I thought that was.
No! No! Okay. Yeah. You feel dizzy.
That's bad. No, that's really bad. That's really, really bad.
Guys, I'm not feeling too good.
Only because I know what.
Yeah, I know what happened.
Yeah, I wish it didn't spell it out for you there, but it does, so.
Oh, I know what that is, dude.
I know, it sucks.
This is bad.
Alright.
So, but we don't know what's happening.
So I'm just a freaking werewolf now, Greg?
No, not yet.
I feel a little dizzy. You got hit with a... Dude bit you, so.
Ow, guys.
But yeah, these guys might have some theories after the battle, so. Fluffles, you're up.
I guess we do know a little bit about
Alright.
I know it.
Yeah. Wait. So Julio can go for a bite while he's constricting, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, wait.
Make him a snake.
Does that affect, like, the werewolf's attacks? Or is that just he
can't move when he's grappled.
Mm. Oh, that's...
Okay. So say if Mevidus ran away, he would have to break the grapple before chasing.
Okay. So would he get, like, an attack of opportunity if Mev tried to, like, run away?
Yes, he would.
Oh. Okay, well...
But it would just be the one rather than...
And that's a miss.
Next turn. Yeah.
That's a miss.
Alright, what do you got?
Disengage.
You got Waka Tiki?
Yep. Wouldn't hit anyways.
Arrow soars over his head. I guess you were going for the headshot, but he's like tall and you overcompensated.
Oh, man.
Brothers.
I wish Corbin. I wish Julio wasn't on this guy.
It's not Corbin's turn yet.
Corbin shot.
Yeah, Corbin shot right before Mev.
Yeah, it's our turn then, Corbin. Then
Let's
Mev.
Go.
Let's go.
All right. Dang. The twin 23s. Oh. Roll that damage.
Oh, man.
One lower that time. Kratos. Okay, so yeah. He is now looking noticeably weaker as you guys continuously pummel into him.
I want Julio to get off him. I want to finish this off in style.
We're not even over yet.
Well, Julio's like around his legs right now because that still works. So.
Yeah, I know, but okay. I feel like if I do what I want, if I want to do
it. You gonna kneecap him?
Okay, your freaking style points don't take priority over having him constricted. All right, okay?
Mevidus, you're up.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm gonna...
I got him! Don't got him!
Can I disengage and, like, back up?
Yeah.
And still use a bonus action?
Yes, you can.
Okay, I'm gonna do that, and I'm going to cast Healing Word on myself.
All right. Let's see how much healing you get.
Yep. Hold on. Healing Word. Okay, 5, I guess, all right?
All right, now let's see if we can make a vampire snake, or a werewolf snake, a weresnake.
A weresnake?
What?
Oh, no.
Can't just attack Julio.
I mean, he can.
Yeah, he like looks around the battlefield and wants to go for a different target, but realizes he's constricted.
I think he has to break it with the roll. He
does, and that's his
action. Like, you can't really attack him. You can't attack a snake on his leg, though.
No, he can. Fair. He can absolutely like claw at it, but
he would hurt himself.
He could.
There's
yeah.
no way.
But regardless, he is going to go for. Let's see. Let's go
matter.
For Kratos. He's closer. It really doesn't.
Reaction! The pressure! Right, the second one!
Okay. Wow. Oh no!
Missed regardless.
Dang! Well, that wasn't the reaction one.
I know.
Alright,
so
this is the one I wanted.
Yeah.
Yes!
Good job with the reaction.
It doesn't matter anyways, he didn't hit.
He wouldn't
have
hit me regardless.
Oh, 21, my god.
I'm like, oh, wait a minute.
That's bad almost. Like, those werewolves aren't even really doing anything.
Shut up!
Four of us, just one.
Shut up!
I don't think you realize the consequences of what just happened a turn ago.
No, I don't.
You're up, Tiger.
You will. That's metagaming.
Well, it's not metagaming.
I'm staying in character.
I'm just talking about my character. We know what's going to happen.
My character knows werewolf history, man.
Yeah, you might even have a chance of knowing it, being a ranger. But
I might know a little bit, too. I didn't ever get to do a check.
Yeah, maybe.
Alright,
Fluffles.
Our turn? Oh, no, Fluffles.
That was not sharpshooter, yeah. Obviously.
I'll assume you call it out whenever you want to do it.
Yeah.
So. Yeah. Alright, roll that damage.
Pew pew!
Yeah, good shot. Alright, he takes the arrow and he like staggers back a little, almost trips up on the snake around his legs.
Yeah. Julio Speaking bite, of which, by the way. Oh.
Yeah,
Julio. Alright, brothers. Okay. He got a good constrict damage off. Right. He did his job.
Alright, that's two hits. You guys are consistent today. Uh-huh. Alright. He's now looking kind of distraught. So. As you see, like, he's bleeding from, like, several wounds right now. You see, like, his forearm is actually kind of, like, broken and, like, just, like, completely broken and twisted one way from, like, the numerous hammer hits. But it's, like, still just, like, muscled and rippled. He is... Yeah. He lets out a long howl.
My ears.
And as he does... Bang!
Oh, God.
Nothing.
Guys, I'm not feeling too good. Though even though I'm not feeling too good, I still can't fight my natural tendency to mock this guy and go,
yeah, you're just like dizzy right now. It's nothing serious.
What are you doing?
Aren't
you a cute little
puppy? You have a good chance of hurting him here.
Hey,
yeah.
What's his role? Yeah. Wow.
It's just a d20.
For 3 psychic damage.
Yeah, what do you say to him?
Aren't you a cute little puppy? You want to go for a walk?
He just looks at you, like, straight up confused.
Like a dog does when he tilts his head slightly, like...
Yeah, he is now going to just look around panicked and try to break free of the snake wrapped around his legs. So I believe it's a DC 14 he has to beat.
Yes.
Nope. He like slashes, but Julio just constricts around his legs. He like almost trips as he reaches out to slash at you guys as you continue hitting him. So, Fluffles.
Okay, Julio bite first, and he lands it!
That's a bite!
The first one!
Alright, how does Julio kill... No.
Oh, great.
Like bites him around on the leg.
Exactly, as he's trying to like claw Julio off him, Julio just like bites and like that completely breaks his concentration.
And then I go for the sharpshooter.
Okay. Sharpshooter.
Bang! Ooh,
you hit.
Yes!
Yeah! Alright, anything fancy you want to do with this? As this werewolf looks down, he like looks towards you and it's just like a slow motion shot of it like going down the shaft
I
of the
just
arrow.
Aim into for your the head.
Okay.
Like, I fed you.
Shoot off his neck.
Yeah, you fire with your sharpshooter shot. The arrow just like flies right towards him and just goes straight through his mouth and pokes through the back of his head.
Oh! I just did 28 damage.
He staggers
there. All your stuff doubles, huh?
And then.
Plus 10. Yeah, first one does, right?
Plus 10.
Oh, plus 10.
Just plus 10, so it's 28.
Yeah, Tiger, that's a 28 damage attack. Yeah, this thing just like, he struggles and then falls down to the ground. Julio slowly slithers off his legs and then just crawls right back up to you.
Alright, Plato.
Alright, I guess I'm gonna cut this thing's head off now.
Yeah, that's what I was kinda hoping for. Good shot, Fluffles.
I'm gonna Reinhardt, like, bring down the axe on him too.
Anyway, Mev, are you feeling alright?
Just a little dizzy, but he did so bite me.
While Great Kurt is talking on, I'm just gonna pick up the head. Hey guys, look what I got!
I imagine it's
cut
just
off
because
with your nice axe, no problem.
Yeah,
I did Reinhardt lose a decent amount of blood, so maybe I should just sit down here for a second.
I'm gonna cure wounds him too, Mev.
Okay.
I'm gonna just do a history check to see if I know what werewolf he's.
Yeah, I'm gonna.
Is.
I guess I'll history check too.
Okay,
there's no reason.
Yeah, Fluffles, you never heard of him. Vlado, you recall knowing a little bit about it when Kratos was talking about it at one point, but you were like, "Nah, man, I like vampires better." Back
yeah,
in
I do like vampires
studying.
Better.
So,
do I?
Yeah,
do
Kratos is the resident expert on this. You know that there is definitely a transmittable disease when it comes to werewolves.
Why do you ask?
You getting bit by that werewolf is not a good thing.
Well, I imagine getting bit by anything isn't a good thing.
Well, yes.
Do we take him back to town? Like, how long do we have? Do
you know? Wait, are they like poisonous or something? How long do you have what?
It's not how long a for what? Poisonous thing. Well, it's wait, more wait, of wait, a... Wait.
Stop, stop, stop. How long does he have? Do we have to go to town or...
How long do I have for what? What are you saying?
Calm down, Bev. Calm down.
What are you talking about?
Calm down.
Yeah, what's gonna happen?
Do we go to town now?
We have to. We gotta hurry.
Okay, let's go.
But wait, hurry, what's what? Happening?
We'll explain on the way. Come on, let's go. Get no. Cheryl ready. Make her run
but
fast.
But if it's like a snake bite and we it's need not, an it's anti-venom, not a snake bite. No, then we should grab some blood, right?
It's not as simple as that.
Are you
it's
sure?
More, it's more of a...
Are you sure? We have
just,
a bottle,
just go.
Right?
Load him onto the cart. Let's go.
Yeah, let's just go. We'll explain when we get back to Helgen.
Okay.
All right. So Corvin kind of looks nervously as you guys like panning. You're probably about the same amount of nervous as Mev.
And Tiger's probably confused too. He's like,
Yeah, because Tiger, you got bit too.
But he saved it.
Yeah, but you also felt, you know, a little dizziness.
Well, you don't know though.
But if it's a snake bite, I want an anti-venom, so we need blood. Like now.
You can grab your own blood. Oh,
where's the bottle? We had a bottle. Give me the bottle.
We have a bottle?
We have a brass bottle that won't do you anything.
Yeah, we will. I'll fill it with blood and then I'll make an anti-venom.
Whose blood?
Works.
No one's
blood. Okay, whatever. You do that. We're gonna load him onto the cart.
Fine,
Mev,
here,
stay
take
still.
The bottle.
Yeah, that's right.
Let us know if you feel anything.
Alright, so you
slit
go
the
to
tendon of the wolf and fill it with the blood.
Alright. As you open up this
I'm
brass
holding
bottle,
this thing's head.
Smoke starts billowing out of the bottle.
What the?
Great.
What?
It's
a genie?
Great.
I thought it wasn't a genie.
I told you it was a genie. I guess we don't even notice this yet. We're over here loading your mouth.
Yeah.
Yeah, you see suddenly
guys,
Tiger is obscured in a cloud of smoke.
What the?
Guys?
Fluffles?
Is Fluffles on fire?
What's
the
smoke
going
starts
on?
Expanding and covers Julio. It's starting to crawl past Kratos.
Close the bottle!
I don't know where...
Yeah, it's just a brass, a small brass
just
bottle with
it.
A regular cork.
Okay, close just it.
Cork it up. Yeah.
Guys, do we have another bottle?
Still there, but it slowly begins to dissipate. You probably walk out of it before that happens.
Give me back the bottle.
No, I'm keeping this. This thing's cool.
You've
you
had
serious?
This for weeks.
By the way, aren't we in a rush or something?
Yes,
yeah,
we hurry
about
up.
I don't have much time. Can we please get going, please?
Yes,
do we
yes,
have
yes,
another
yes.
bottle?
Just put
no,
it in your water
don't.
Skin or something.
Oh, yeah. Fine. I empty my water skin and fill with blood.
All right, let's go, Harry, before
okay,
before
you drink
we
the blood?
Run out of time.
No. Gross.
Come on,
what?
Cheryl, come
I
on.
I empty
fast.
Out the water skin by drinking the water, for starters.
Alright, let's just go.
I don't want to die of dehydration.
Smart about it.
Alright. Alright, everyone.
Now, does somebody want to tell me what's going on?
No.
Why don't you guys tell me what's going on?
No.
A bit too.
You don't want to tell me what's going on.
Well, we
nobody
do, but you're panicking.
Because nobody's telling me what's going on.
Well,
dude,
I told you. We'll
either.
Explain to you when we get to Helgen.
You mean we're gonna travel all the way there half a day and you're not gonna talk to me at all about what's
all right,
happening?
Cheryl's gonna go faster than she's ever gone before.
Okay,
you'll be fine.
That's weird.
Can we get some sleep? Cheryl's
I don't
tired.
Like
no, 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 no.
We
don't
we
have
okay.
Thing. Here, take 20 more silver.
Why are you paying okay. Money to make Cheryl go faster?
Maybe we should kill
maybe
them. I don't trust them.
Maybe
money makes Cheryl go around.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Maybe it goes faster. I don't know. Let's go. Let's just end up in Helgen as quickly as possible.
Okay.
Okay, so you begin this slow
trek. Yeah, we got the head.
Why is it slow? We just made this dude 20 silver. He better be rushing.
Yeah, he pushes Cheryl. Cheryl's tired. She's been traveling all day.
Poor Cheryl. I feel terrible for Cheryl.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're all kind of feeling tired, too. It's definitely affecting how... comfortable you feel, Mevis.
I think we're running off of adrenaline right now.
Yeah,
you guys are still like, you guys are panicking and everyone else is like, what? Mev, you're just concerned.
Yeah, because nobody's telling me anything.
Mm-hmm. We don't want to
like,
because
you're panicking.
Because you
you're not telling me anything.
All right, are we
well,
in Helgen?
I'm not telling you anything because
you're
we panicking.
There
well,
yet?
I'm panicking because you're not telling me anything.
Are we
I'm
there
just watching
yet?
Mev, too.
Why are you
same
staring
way I was watching
at me?
The werewolf.
Why are you staring? Can you tell me what's happening instead of just looking at me?
I get
you're
up
fine,
and,
you're fine.
I get up in his face and look in his eyes.
What are you
just
doing?
Just like opening his eyes up.
Yeah.
What,
like...
you...
what kind of check would you like to roll?
Medicine check.
I don't know if we end. Would it be medicine?
Yeah, medicine potentially.
I'll throw that.
You're checking for like general signs.
Yeah.
Yeah, you look at him. He you know, his eyes are. There's a little bit of redness in there just from lack of sleep, but nothing seems too strange.
Does nobody care about the Fluffles getting bit?
There's nothing there. You.
Okay, let me see you. Let me see you. Come here.
Look at. You look into his eyes and you see like.
You guys need to stop metagaming.
There's kind of like a dark sphere with like a slit going right down the middle.
It's not metagaming.
Dark, what's wrong with your eyes?
It is metagaming. We both got Fluffles. Bit. What's wrong with your eyes? Crap about Fluffles.
Yeah, that's true. We did both get bit. Technically, none of us would see anything with those turns.
Yeah.
That's my bad.
Yeah, you look at Fluffles' eyes and there's like a slit going down the middle.
Fluffles, there's a slit in your eye.
I'm a cat. What do you think?
His eyes are always like that. Either
are
way.
Are you sure?
Move over. Let me look at him.
They are always like that.
Be concerned because we both.
Yeah, Kratos, you realize
your
brother's an idiot.
Freaking out.
You're an idiot. He's fine.
Are you sure?
Yes.
Okay. Just making sure, you know. At least I think you're fine, Fluffles. I don't think you're dying.
You've never
okay.
seen a cat before.
He's
no.
Better.
Well, he's
I don't look at your
than...
eyes. They freak me out.
I think he's better off than Memphis anyway.
Anyway. Who are we going to see? Where are you taking me?
Somebody. We're going back to the.
Who are we gonna go see?
We're going
I just
to,
have
hell
to go
temple?
Back to the Earl.
The Jarl's not gonna know what to do.
Jarl. Yeah, the Jarl.
Are we going to get paid?
Well,
is that why we're rushing back?
No.
I mean, I'm for getting paid like everybody else, but you're freaking me out here.
Yeah, we could have camped.
Maybe
for
she'll
the
know
night.
More, because I don't know how to do.
I mean,
it.
She was. She
tell
said
us
people
what
were
you
dealing
know.
With it.
I draw my bow and threaten them.
It's like you could hit us anyways. Calm down.
Oh,
okay.
You think I can't?
Okay, fine.
I'm probably the only person here who can hit you.
I didn't want to do this.
Yes!
Oh, no.
I turn into Vlados and cast Charm Person.
Alright, you know what to do, Vlados. This has happened to you like 6 times.
Wisdom saving throw?
Yep, wisdom saving throw.
Saving throw, right?
Yep.
Really? Come on.
Alright.
Hey, Vlado, old buddy.
What do you want?
Tell me what's going on here.
Yeah, you consider him a good friend of yours, and you don't see any reason not. You don't see any reason to lie to him.
I smack Vlado on the face.
What's going on, bud?
What was that for? Why are you slapping me?
Don't worry, I did it for a reason.
Doesn't do anything. It's not
trying to break this spell.
It doesn't work that way.
I thought it would.
It doesn't work that way. No.
No.
Generally, when someone casts a spell, you have to hit the caster to break concentration.
So, Vlado?
What do you want? We're in a hurry here, man.
Mev,
what's going on?
And why are we in a hurry?
Because you're in danger.
Why am I in danger?
You were bit by that werewolf. We gotta make sure nothing's happened to you.
What could happen to me?
Hey, no, listen. Something might not be wrong with you, but we gotta make sure.
What could happen to me?
Let me just tell Fluffles and Khajiit later. Okay. Fluffles.
Something bad could happen, you know? You saw how that old man
getting
turned. Like, that might.
Wait, are you saying I could turn into one of those things?
Possibly. I'm not the greatest on my history of them. Kratos knows more, but.
And you guys wouldn't let me get blood for an anti-venom?
It's not how this works.
How do you know? Are you a werewolf expert?
Yes, actually.
How are we supposed to get cured then?
I dabbled.
I dabble in this.
So what's the cure?
That I'm not aware of. That's why we're going back to the Yarl.
So how do you know it's not blood?
Because I'm pretty sure it wouldn't be blood.
What if we get to this place
and
we're like,
we
need the werewolf's blood?
You can't be doing it.
Then you're going to be prepared, Fluffles. Anyway,
Also, Fluffles,
can Cheryl go any faster, Corbin?
We have the head. There's blood in it. We'll be fine.
It'll drain out by the time we get there.
Here, put it upside down. You hold it.
Okay. Well, I'm kind of annoyed that you guys didn't. You know, share this with me.
We don't want you to be more crazy, okay? Just calm down. All right?
I'm less worried now that I at least know what's going on. It
could have
been
a lot worse.
I'm less worried.
He could turn into a werewolf.
At least he's not gonna die instantly.
Hey, if he was gonna die instantly, we would have cured wounds. Don't
you know what would really make me feel better, Kratos?
What do you want?
Can I have 5 gold, bud?
No.
Wow,
we're
give 5 gold to a
dying man. I have to give him 5 gold.
Dying man. Give him some silver.
I'll hand you 5 copper, Mev.
Wow.
There you go,
even when he's charmed,
it's basically
charm
the same thing as gold.
5 gold.
I mean, how much does the charm really do, though? Because
I don't know. That's
I'm already a really good friend with you.
punch him in the side of the head.
Exactly.
Well,
you're
even more of a friend now, so like
punch Mev in the side of the head.
What are you doing? Trying to get gold at this kind of time?
What?
As I tossed him 5 copper, like there you
completely in character too. I'm sick. Feel bad for me.
You may be sick, but that doesn't mean
how
you can swindle people.
How much does that charm spell actually affect me?
Like, you don't have to do everything he says, but like...
Would it make me give him the 5 gold?
You just can't...
No, he can't, like, say, just give me the 5 gold. You'll probably think, I mean, if you need it, sure.
Make him feel better. Make me feel better, too, if I got 5 gold.
Anyway, I guess...
Yeah, and you're already a generous guy, so... It's up to you.
Well, I'm generous?
Yeah, you're always giving
out with
our
money. Gold.
With silver, yeah.
If I look on your character sheet, there's a charity thing added, and Mev seems to be in need of charity right now. So.
But does not, he's not helping him, though, in any way, shape, or form.
But think of it from this way. Panda has no reason to, you know, be negative towards Mev right now, and Mev is so persuasive. I'm pretty sure Vlado thinks that Mev might need it right now.
If it's better than like, okay, if it's better than 12,
yeah. Okay.
I'll give you.
We'll
I'll
do an insight.
5 gold.
We'll do a persuasion versus insight.
Okay.
Go for it.
Persuasion.
God.
Yeah, he beats you with
you
an 8.
5 gold and 5 copper.
And 5 copper, nice.
Have you no humility?
Hey, Mev, can I get that copper off you, homie?
Oh, yeah, I got you, dude. Here you go.
You want 5 copper?
Because okay. It makes me smile.
I've made 5 gold. I might be a werewolf, but at least I made 5 gold off the deal.
You're trying to get gold at a time like this when you can instantly lose your entire mind for the
night?
Don't
worry, Mev. We'll make a pact. If I turn into a wolf, you kill me. If you turn into a wolf, I'll kill you.
Sounds good.
Yeah.
I just hope I can kill you when you turn into a wolf.
Yeah, you might have some troubles. I don't know if Khajiit can turn into wolves.
Yeah,
but...
you're already a cat. Isn't that like a conflict of interest?
Maybe. Maybe I'll have twice the claws. That'd
Corbin,
be cool.
How close are we?
We've only been traveling like 30 minutes.
Oh, how much going any faster?
She's trying.
Fast forward.
So yeah, you guys travel through the night.
Wait, I got an idea. Let's give Cheryl the haste orb.
Oh, I like to? Half want to try that, but I doubt it'll work. But,
I totally
you know,
want to do it.
We could try.
Mev's holding the orbs.
Mev is holding the orbs.
You know what? That's a pretty good idea, Fluffles.
This is a pretty dire situation, and usually speed doesn't help us too much, so.
What is the green? Is it the green one?
Yes.
Okay,
is
we
it?
Give. Yes.
Oh, no.
It is.
Yes, it is.
Those play mind games. Don't buy into this crap.
Yes.
Don't let the DM get in your head.
I give Cheryl... I say, hey, Corbin! Feed Cheryl this!
What is it?
It's candy, don't worry.
She'll love it.
So it's like a sugar cube.
It's like a sugar cube.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is.
I mean...
If there were 50-100 sugar cubes put into this one little orb, then yeah, it's kind of like
what
that.
Is it, apple flavored? Cheryl loves apples.
Yeah, it's a green apple flavor. It's
yeah,
apple.
Like a Granny Smith.
Granny Smith.
Oh yeah, it's a sugar cube, you could say that.
Yeah. So he stops the wagon, goes up to Cheryl.
Why'd you stop?
Well, he has to
is he gonna get off the wagon and feed it to Cheryl while the wagon's moving?
He could have hopped on her back.
I don't shove think
it. So. You want to stick your hand in your horse's
mouth? Politely
in movement.
Feeds Cheryl the small green orb.
Candy.
Cheryl eats that candy. It's not as sweet as Cheryl was expecting.
Okay,
but,
Cheryl likes it.
Corvin gets back up and then gives Cheryl the good old yeah.
Yeah.
Cheryl takes off. Let me just show you guys just for fun what the haste spell does. Let's see.
Triples the movement speed.
Yeah, double the movement speed. Yeah, target speed is doubled.
It gains bonus to AC?
Yeah.
What? Wow, that's a good spell.
And an additional attack.
Wow, that would have been good in battle.
Way to go, Cheryl.
Yeah, Cheryl just dashes ahead faster than ever. It's ignoring all that. Now, let's see one thing. When the spell ends, the target can't move or take actions until the next turn. Oh, yeah, it's 6 seconds, so... After,
She's gonna stop for 6 seconds. Okay, let's go!
After a minute of just taking off, Cheryl just, like, slows down and just, like, stops for a second, but then just, like, keeps trotting along. So it doesn't last for a long time.
Oh, okay.
Cheryl does make some good ground with the haste orb. So.
Okay.
Kind of worth it, I guess.
Yeah, you guys manage to get a little closer. The moon begins to slowly rise into the middle of the sky.
Rise?
Do we put a blanket over him?
The moon, like, positions. You know, moon.
I don't think that the werewolf thing just stops because of a sheet of fabric.
I don't know. Yeah. I don't know how this works.
Didn't you claim to be a werewolf expert?
No. I said Kratos was the expert. I just kind of know a little bit about him. I read the same book, but I was more into vampires.
Idiot. Just for fun, roll a history check, see how into how much you know about vampires.
I bet I know more of vampires than you do.
Yes. I knew more about werewolves.
He talks like he's really into vampires, but he actually knows nothing. Like, he's a big fan of Twilight.
He's into Twilight, but not actual vampires.
You never studied these books that Gordius gave us, huh?
You're like, I studied more religion.
We're like, how do you know about vampires? You're like, I saw a play about them once.
It was interesting.
It was really
I had a higher history role on freaking werewolves.
Yeah. Well, Kratos had a higher initial history role on werewolves, too, so.
I think I had like a 12 or 13 on my
Actually, role. I had a higher one than you. I had a...
Yeah,
the second role you still had higher.
Yeah, true.
You know, I know a lot about vampires.
Do you, though?
Trust me. Oh, I know a lot.
As the moon continues to move and hits right in the middle of the night at midnight.
I feel like vampires are undead, so I probably do know of it.
But I guess I'm still watching.
Ooh!
Why?
Attention, that's why.
That's mean. That's not only mean to them, that's mean to us. That's not fair. You should know what happens next.
Sorry.
You'll find out.
I was actually going to make a break just so I could figure out what actually does happen, but I kind of read. And now I know. So.
Oh, God.
It's a dark, no metagaming.
I'm not metagaming.
I know, I'm just saying, don't go looking it up.
I'm not.
Yeah, I trust you.
I wouldn't.
I wouldn't necessarily trust you if, you know, I didn't say it, so. Yeah, just me saying it.
I just know what that one word meant, that's all I know.
Oh yeah, yeah. That's...
What, lycanthropy?
Yeah.
That's
perfectly reasonable.
Yeah, I'm like, that's a fair assumption.
Dumb people don't know what it means, man, you never know.
It's lucky,
a lot of people don't, but
it's so makes an ass out of you and me.
Potentially a werebard.
I mean, let's be honest. If Mev turns, we're just gonna push him off the cart.
I mean, is there any way to get a werewolf?
Imagine how crazy it would be if control. I killed one of the brothers.
That'd be so dope.
And then I like came back to normal form. The resent I would feel for, you know, the resentment from the other brother. You killed my brother.
Oh, you'd be dead. You would just... Well, it depends.
I'm
no.
Pretty sure
if you
killed
Vlado, you'd be dead.
Oh,
if you killed 100%. Kratos, you might live.
I don't think so.
He's based on vengeance.
Yeah, but I still don't think so.
Yeah, your no, I'm just saying that would be the only chance.
I don't think your oath would probably...
No, my oath would allow me.
What's a... Like, he's honestly an innocent man.
You know?
He didn't have control of himself. You know? I don't think your oath would allow you. You protect the innocent.
I think it would.
It would be iffy.
I'd definitely make... kill him for the 100 gold.
Yeah, that's perfectly fine. You're a scumbag.
Part
it makes
of me
sense.
Feels like I don't know. I'm greedy, but also part of me feels like Mev's a pretty useful ally.
No. I think I would kill him.
I'm believing that.
I think I would.
Well, let's hope it doesn't come to that, sucker. Come
let's
at
hope it
me.
Doesn't.
I'm basing it off of loyalty to my brother. He takes top priority over anything.
So happy this guy didn't turn Corvin into a werewolf.
I would have loved it if Corvin became a werewolf. I was thinking that after I turned. I'm like, ooh, I wonder if...
I love how it's probably more likely that you would kill a werewolf Mev than a werewolf Corvin.
I know, Corvin's insane.
I'd kill Corvin in a heartbeat. I love Corvin, but...
I don't think I could bring myself to kill Corvin.
I'd steal Cheryl.
So at this point, though, I mean, do I have more AC and more health points than Corvin?
Yeah. Yeah, you're kind of battle hardened a little bit.
But then
you know?
Again, actually, would I not have my armor if I turned into a werewolf?
There's probably specific stats for it.
Mm-hmm.
I guess we'll have to find out.
Yeah.
Next time, you might not even turn.
Skyrim D&D.
Yeah, I mean, I rolled a secret die, so.
Yeah, that 4, right?
Mm-hmm. Critical 4.
Oh god, you're turning, you're dead. We're gonna have to kill you, Mev. Start making
you guys know I'm just saying words. So, the 4s are upon us. So yeah, anyone have anything they would like to announce or share with the audience before we leave?
Use the bathroom.
Okay.
Thank you, Dark.
I hope you guys don't like Mev's character.
Yu-Gi-Oh! RP currently going.
Tiger's going for 10k. Go help him out.
Yeah, man, I'm going for 10k by New Year's.
If you guys can help these guys out, if you haven't already subbed to Tiger, he's approaching 10k. Mev's approaching 9k. Panda's approaching 1k.
I'm at 21,000.
Yeah, same thing.
I just hit it.
Okay, Panda might start uploading.
Yeah. If you subscribe to me, I might start.
If you subscribe to me, I'll give all of you a dollar.
And of course, all your support on this channel, watching the series, is always welcome as well. But I'll let you guys continue doing your own roleplay in the chat, as you love to do. Thank you for watching this stream.
Check out Pinky Squad.
Yeah, Pinky Squad, Pinky Squad.
Everybody happy holidays, too.
Most importantly, this is going to be the last live stream until the
New Year
holidays. Yeah.
Probably the 4th, yeah.
So, yeah. Thank you guys for an awesome year. And thank you for watching.
Yeah, I hope you guys can survive without a D&D without a week.
Yeah, because we can't do one next week.
I think all the delicious food and presents will make up for it.
Well, Tiger's not going to be here next week.
Oh, yeah, he might not
I guess if we did it on, like, the Saturday or the Friday.
We'll see. We'll keep you guys updated on Twitter.
Yeah, we'll see if we can figure it out. If not, we'll see you guys next time regardless.
Yeah.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. So, we'll see you guys then.
Yeah. Right.
Goodbye.
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 Okay.
Werewolves.